So we have four people that we're going to take, or three of us. So one of us is going to control two people.
So all right, so we're starting off. We ended at phase 8 of the settlement phase. Which is preparing and departing survivors. So we will now do that. We're going to leave. Was it Gregory is behind?
Gary's being left behind. Yeah.
Gary's being left behind. He got beat up a little bit in the last fight. And
yeah. He really took a chest wound. Yeah. And that means he's a liability in battle now. Gwen has an eye wound, which is just as bad, really. But she's really insane, which actually is good. So we're taking her anyways.
I will take Timothy.
Actually, it's questionable whether Gwen's better, because she's got that, she has Tourette's. She got hit in the head and now has Tourette's.
I'm lost at least, but, oh, we had an extra one. So we had five then.
Yeah, that's right. Well, the first adventure, we had Timothy, Gwen, Gary, and Kate. But then Timothy meditated for a year and couldn't go on the next hunt. And so we got Chris to go with us. We made Chris was one of the nine or the 10 people that was there. He joined it.
So playing in this is me and Jason again, and then we have Chris, who...
Don't take Gary, we're leaving him behind.
Oh, he's the one we can't take.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to take Kate, because I don't want to take Chris.
Okay.
Chris was unable to make it over last time due to phone complications, so he's now here with us this time.
And I'm not up to speed with anything yet, so... Well, the minimum. Yep. So I'm probably going to ask a lot of questions that has already been covered.
So we decided we're going to do another hunt of the White Lion. Don't think we're quite ready for the Screaming Antelope.
Yeah. We need to fight. It's not that we're not ready for it. I think we can do it. But we want to get another lion tooth to build a second lion boat beast guitar, because then that particular fighter will be really good.
So should I
copy this stuff onto here?
Okay. Yeah. Oh, geez, it's going to take me an hour just to work out where everything is.
So the key one is this one, your insanity of 7, I'll mark that there. And you can mark off that we have encourage. So everyone starts off with this dodge ability, and then because Timothy gave us language, now we can speak to each other and encourage each other, so we have that ability. You've been on 2 hunts, so mark off 2 hunt XP there. Got one more.
Sorry, not just a point.
And then you have.
I was dying of truths.
Strategist as your fighting arts. So there, fighting arts, right? Strategist, and we'll have to look what that does. It allows you to like place some terrain elements on the board when we fight. You can write your name up here, Kate. She's female.
Don't assume agenda.
Yeah. No, she is too. She already chosen.
You mean it? You can mean it can already be assigned?
Yeah.
How dare you say that?
She could change it. Web efficiency 1. Okay.
Oh, we didn't choose.
And that's it. So far.
Cool.
We didn't choose Timothy's extra ability.
Choose it?
Remember, he has.
Did he get? Okay, go for it.
Oh, claw.
Do what you have to do.
I'm glad I didn't bold. Take black.
That is a story event.
But it would have been hard to read, but also Shane probably would have taken it from me if he wanted.
Oh, you lose. I wouldn't know what to look at. Oh yeah, that was highlighted.
Where is bold?
So I think Gwen should take. Whisker harp and one of those.
It would have been nice if they'll make.
Yeah, take those 3 things and.
You should do that, Shane. You should transfer all these onto magnet sheets.
What I saw that was really cool. I'm gonna find them. Is one guy in line actually had like a plastic insert.
Yeah.
So you can actually slide those
in. Oh yeah.
A little sleeve.
They're coin collector.
Yep. I just gotta find where I can get them, they've also done, they've made up character sheets that you can lay it over.
I just find magnets oddly satisfying.
Yeah.
Just the snap.
You're still on that magnet kick, aren't you?
Hey?
You're still on that magnet kick.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna get that real big one.
So, what you want to do here is put this there, and then put this here so that the red, those two red things look up.
Okay.
And then put this here so that blue one hooks up. Okay. And now, because you've made all the connections you need to,
yep,
you get this extra evasion ability.
So where should I put that guy?
You could just write it here if you want, but or just remember it's here. Either one.
I need to make notes because I'm new to all this game stuff.
Yeah, because you've got that set up, you get the plus one evasion.
A little backstory is I met Jay in
prison.
PD7.
Knew it.
Grade 7, otherwise known as prison.
I knew it.
1987 is when I met Jay.
Yeah.
I wasn't even born yet.
He lived probably what, 2 kilometers up the road,
something like that. Yeah.
He had to trek in the snow.
Yeah, yeah.
Just to see your buddy.
That's right.
In the prison days. Yep. I knew it.
Well, Jay was our resident. Unfortunate.
Unfortunate.
Yeah, because you didn't have cable TV. Like, even if it was only 2 kilometers down, didn't have cable TV.
I lived in the rural part. Jesus,
but 87, like, that wouldn't have been, would have cable have been, like, common? So when I was growing up, like, Fox, our equivalent is Foxtel.
Mm.
And, like, it wasn't that common that everyone had it.
This city we lived in, Kamloops, there was 2 channels, Channel 6 and Channel 4, that were just, like, everyone got those.
Yeah.
And then, I mean, you had, like, I don't know how many.
We had cable TV.
Channels.
More than that. 20 or 30.
How the other half live?
Yeah.
No, it wasn't the fact that they couldn't. Like, you know, due to monetary reasons, it just wasn't available.
Yeah, we didn't bring people out that way.
Okay, what do we do?
So now,
We got to do roll a d10.
For what?
Because we never got Timothy his. Courage.
We'll go for it.
So for his bold.
10.
Sweet.
Sounds good.
Plus 1 permanent speed.
Oh, that's really good.
Wow.
Damn. Oh, he's getting these then.
Oh, yeah, for... see if he's our assassin.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, that'd be sweet.
So, you can see with these shields here, everywhere there's a shield, there's going to be a little icon next to it.
Yep.
This is the belt, this is the head, this is the body.
Class.
On, where are they? Here. You're going to write these numbers in these places.
Armor?
Yeah.
Per area?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, wait. How did he get that last courage? That was in settlement, wasn't it?
I don't remember.
So, no, he gets a plus 1 permanent accuracy.
And you can write a 2 here. This is important.
Is that, like, so they get a level every, is that basically what that is?
No, survival is like a resource you have that you can spend to do special things during the fight. One of them is if a monster attacks you and they roll the location die, they hit you in the waist, and you look at your waist and you be like, I have no armor there and I've already got a heavy damage there, this could kill me. You can just say, okay, I'm going to spend one of my survival and dodge that roll, and it gets canceled.
So but does that... I don't know, because you guys are on 3 already. So where does the 2 come from?
The 2, normally we all start with 0. And then we have a thing in our settlement that just when we leave for an adventure, we get plus 1. And then you've got these stone noses, which when you arrive... Oh, actually, no, you'll only have 1 so far.
Me?
Yeah.
Was he going to play Chris?
I'm playing Kate.
Okay. Yeah, you only have 1.
I didn't want to play Chris and make it personal.
When we arrive at the monster, you're going to get another plus 1.
Yeah.
Are these all mine here?
These are for your 2. You're going to run 2.
Unless you want me to run 2 and then I'll run the box.
Okay.
So, that's why I just grabbed Timothy.
I got it. I need the bone sword.
You can take the bone sword, we each get cloth.
Yeah.
Stone nose. You gonna only leave Timothy with the guitars?
Timothy!
He can have the boots.
Do we have extra?
Does Timothy...
Plus 1 survival. Okay.
Well, I've got 3 pieces of armor, you can give some...
No, you need... This needs to happen. and then for this combination, we want that. We want this, that to happen.
Okay.
And then this, everyone has one of these, so right. you're good. I'm Chris.
Is two understanding. So Timothy will be our nice little bearded guy.
Okay.
He seems like the elder.
Sure.
And you have
Kate.
What did we use for Kate last time?
I've always been using these. These are the two I've been using. So this has been, up until now, this has been Gary and this has been Gwen. So this is Gwen.
So we'll give Kate there.
Yeah, and this is,
what up, Kate?
And this is Chris.
Hey.
Hey, there's nothing in the rules that says you can't.
This is a PG rated.
No, it's not. I never agreed that you're going to be having
certainly not.
Stream. What is she holding? A lantern and a vase?
No, it's a little. It's a little stone faced dagger.
Yeah. The.
We carve faces into it.
We're in some. No, you found it. We're in some kind of like strange land where the ground is all covered in stone faces, and or at least I don't know if
that's
entire.
That was starting cave.
Yeah, the sea of faces or something like that. So it's start.
Terrifying.
Yeah, it is terrifying. It's all terrifying.
Jesus.
Yeah, you don't want to live here.
All right. So that is. Do we have any other story events? We've got all our gear. We got our characters. Gary's out.
Yeah.
Gary.
I will say I started playing South Park.
The fractured butthole.
Fractured butthole. The fractured butthole is what. Fractured butthole.
Yeah.
And so well, that's what the joke is. Fractured butthole.
It's
the superhero one, right?
Yeah.
Fractured butthole.
Yeah.
Holy crap, there was a nice little slap in the face with a bit of racism right at the start.
Yeah.
It's like, choose difficulty. And then you have a bar of five skin tones.
Oh.
Easiest is white.
Yeah.
The hardest is your black. And that actually changes your character color. The skin color. I'm just like, whoa.
They're not exactly normal.
Yeah.
I mean, turning up to.
All right, so let's just get it out there.
All right, so we got our monster, and we got all our survivors and gears. So resources recorded. We did that last time. That's the end of the Sylvan phase. So now we start the hunt. We're doing the white lion, so I'll pull out. So basically this board is actually what's called the hunt board. And we're going to go after a level one white lion.
We're gonna put a bunch of cards here. And then we're gonna like walk forward, flip over the card, and do what it says. And then we'll keep doing that and bad things will happen to us and sometimes the lion will creep forward.
Is it always a bad thing?
Yes. And then if we move on to the lion board, it means we've found the lion and we're hunting it.
Okay.
If the lion moves on to us, it means the lion's found us and is hunting us.
Right.
And the difference will be that if we move on to the lion board, we set up the board, put the lion on, we put ourselves on, and then the lion gets to attack us. If the lion moves on to us, we put out the board, we put the lion on, we put our heroes on, the lion gets to make two attacks on us.
Sick.
Yeah.
I was waiting for you to say that we get to attack the lion first.
Yeah.
And then when it first started with he attacks us first, it's kind of, I think we're beginning to set
that's
the time.
That's setting a good
yeah. Okay. Yeah. We want every advantage we can get.
Yeah.
Gotcha. No throws. Do not throw this game.
All right. So that's 1, 2, 3. And then we need for terrain. We got the tall grass again.
Oh, imagine if you knocked the box over and you shuffled all the cards. You need to get a better system. need to get a better system.
That is the better system.
It needs more knockover insurance.
Yeah, yeah, more protection. Yeah. Like higher. We need to build the wall, Shane.
Or here's the other thing: we just don't knock them over.
Build the walls.
We're adults. We don't need to knock them over.
Dude, accidents happen. Especially when cats are involved.
My cat's really good at that.
Famous last words. I don't want food.
What have you?
I haven't eaten all day.
Well, I've got a shitload of work done on my bench, though.
That's cool. Alright, so... two random crane cards. We have debris.
Building the bench? Or you work with the work that was on the bench?
And
building
debris.
I'm building a bench. Like a bench seat out of wood.
Cool.
I'm moving place next year, so... I'm building like a bench seat and a dining table to fill a space.
So grass is 2, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, we don't do this yet.
We just get everything ready.
Sure, okay.
So I just go on to the... If you need, do you want me to go through and find that? I wouldn't know what to look for.
Well, you look at those.
Like, is it basic, like a basic pictures or something?
Yep.
Yeah, that little
okay.
That guy.
Okay.
Yeah. It'll be it'll be a square that's like one small, it'll be like this.
Yeah. How many? One?
Two.
So we need the basic hunt. See those here. Basic hunt events.
So basic kind of event is going here.
Pretty good looking stuff.
You do woodwork yet?
I can. I don't really do.
You made the bench.
Can.
Was that like woodworking stuff?
Yeah, joinery and.
Yeah.
Cool. Yeah. I wouldn't say I do.
Sure. Yeah. Do you,
but
do you have the tools?
I just got a couple of chisels and.
Okay.
Yeah.
Alright, so now we do the hunt phase. Who's going to take the first step?
Takes 4.
Timothy will. He's been leading the village for a year. He will lead the village in. The White Line has marked this area. If any survivor has 3+ understanding, they realize the area is covered in pneumonia. If they have not innovated it yet, the survivor settlement gains ammonia.
We have ammonia, don't we?
Yes, we do. Ah. And then roll on the hunt, random hunt events.
That was good.
That would have been good if we didn't have ammonia. Yeah. our society would have learned new science if we had already not learned it.
But so, where are we at now?
We're looking for the lion, and we found a bunch of piss. Nice. And our group was like, we already know what this is.
We know this.
All right, let's roll 2d10.
What percentile or add?
So basically, yeah, roll that. Yep, you roll that, and the white is the high dice, so it's a d100.
So you're gonna read it like 61.
Okay. So is that actually a 61?
Yes.
Okay, 61. Frozen lightning. A storm sweeps over the survivors. Deep purple lightning flashes overhead. The bolts freeze amid strike and rain down the survivors. So are jagged, glowing spikes.
Oh.
Each survivor rolls a d10. The lowest scoring survivor, or survivors, I guess it ties, becomes the straggler.
Oh.
Boat crashes beside the straggler, catching them in explosive razor edge crystals. They suffer d5 event damage to 2 random hit locations.
D5.
Archive all fragile gear in your gear grid. Oh. What do we have for fragile
gear? We don't have any fragile. We have frail, but not fragile.
Oh, frail, I should say. Sorry.
Oh, really?
Fragile.
Wait, did we all just get our asses kicked?
One of us is going to. Well, possibly more of us. Is there a difference between fragile and frail?
I'm looking that up now.
I think there will be. I think glass things will be fragile.
Oh, Shane, I really needed to like learn a little bit about this game before I tried to play it. Turn two. Just tell me if I need to do anything.
Yeah.
Until further notice, I'm just going to sit around.
Yeah, no worries. A lot of this stuff just happens like not many choices so coming up right now. So we had to roll on a chart. And the chart told us that we got hit by a lightning storm. So now, after he's done, he's looking up there. We're all gonna roll one of these, and the
lowest.
Person who rolls the lowest is gonna get hit by
the one that this event happens to. Come on, Kate. Well, there's not really any even point cheering for anybody because it's in a
it's
benefit that we all
that's
survive
right,
anyway.
That's right.
So either way, it's just like,
Shane, take the hit.
Timothy.
We don't want either Kate or actually, we really only want Gwen to get hit. That's
frail and fragile are two different
things. Okay, so that doesn't matter then. It doesn't matter. We have no fragile gear.
How do we know where the gear quality is?
It'll say on it somewhere, so it'll also say it down here. See, that thing says frail.
Ah.
Yeah. All right. Rolling for Gwen. Gwen gets a 9. And rolling for Chris. Chris gets a 3.
Ha ha ha, take that, Chris. Kate gets a 5.
Chris, catch up!
Chris! Five. I knew I shouldn't have got a
Chris. Oh, sorry. Oh, no, sorry. Gwen got. This is Gwen's board.
Oh, perfect.
Gwen got hit.
That's
is
exactly
what
we
wanted.
Gwen is. She's pretty badly beaten up, isn't she?
She's blind. She's got Tourette's and she's blind in one eye.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
Gwen's not having a good time.
But
feel bad.
She's
can
well
I take
protected
the hit
with a layer of insanity.
Roll a d10.
Jesus.
Seven. So that would be.
Maybe we should let Gwen go.
4.
Sorry?
4 damage or 2 locations.
Like
so
2 damage. Okay, is that what that works?
Yeah.
It's not 4 to each. Well, guys, that didn't make sense. Alright, location 1 is the waist. So, 1, 2, 3, 2, right? 2.
2, yeah.
And then the other one is the waist again. So, she goes to heavy, but we don't do. Event damage can't do. doesn't do that.
Only like fighting.
When you're fighting, each location can take light damage and then heavy damage, and then when you take the next one, it goes into this chart you got to roll on it, and it, I don't know what you call it, severe damage or something. And while we're not fighting it, you don't do that.
Yeah, it's just a buffer.
Yeah.
So you don't just keep taking damage.
Once we get to the fight, she's in here.
Yep.
All right. So who's gonna?
Chris will lead us to the next one here. What do we get? We got scratching grounds, claw marks, scar the ground. Survivors may choose to investigate. Each survivor that investigates gets +1 courage and rolls on the table. So Chris is gonna do that.
What's the negative side of investigating?
I don't know. So you can suffer event damage to your arms. Nothing happens. Or you get a lion claw, which is what we're here for.
Timothy can get kitted out.
Yeah. So.
Chris, so even if we find that, though, we'd have to go. Do we have to go back to the village before we get the item?
You get a courage for sure.
Yeah, we go back to the village and build it.
I suggest that Timothy do it too, because he's already getting it. He's building up his courage, right?
Yep.
It's only 1 damage to the arm. All right. It's only 1 damage. Damage to the arm.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. 6. What do we get?
Nothing happens.
Nothing happens. All right, Kate. Are you gonna go for it?
I'm that.
Yeah. Okay. Are you gonna search? You're gonna search through this like claw.
So
area?
So each character gets a turn.
A chance. If you want.
If you want to take the gamble to play with it.
That's right.
And what was the worst? What was the worst?
The worst thing is you'll take a point of damage to your arms.
I don't have any armor there.
Yeah. And the best thing that can happen to you is that we find one playing claw.
Because that's what we want. If it's not working. All right. Is that the whole soul?
You take a point of damage.
Yeah. So shit game.
Gwen. Gwen will also look. Gaining him another point of courage.
The question was?
You said we're actually here to find that item.
Yeah.
But is going after the lion more, that's obviously the more
so
important.
The lion will give us a whole bunch of stuff.
Yeah, so like that's the purpose of this mission. But if we find one of those side things, it's a bonus.
That's the spot.
Okay,
right. Yeah.
Okay, so I'm taking one point of light.
Yeah, that's right. And you've got a point of courage.
I get one?
Yep. Gwen will also do that. All right. Gwen's going to roll. Come on.
Oh, I guess I didn't get courage at all, did I?
9. We found it.
Nice.
And that was, I guess, under White Lion Loot?
Yes. It will be under White Lion Loot. If no one investigates, we're all on the hunt then. But we did, so we don't.
Lion Claw.
Perfect.
I'm still yet sort of... I need to find out just how important...
Yeah.
The point of damage is actually... You know what I mean?
Every point of damage.
I don't really
have
a scale yet.
Yeah, every point of damage is needed. You'll see. I wouldn't worry about it yet.
Once both boxes are filled, you start rolling on the chart.
Yeah, and the chart can be like instant death.
Yeah, so these go... Oh, okay.
But last fight...
Yeah, so like it seems pretty important. Like, yeah. I probably shouldn't have done that.
Oh,
if
well,
our sole importance is to take out the lion, like taking stupid gambles on a side thing.
Yeah, this is what we came for, though, if we can guarantee to get it. Also, getting courage is good.
Okay.
So, yeah. It was only 1 point, so.
Okay.
Because, yeah, like what we did right at the beginning, where we rolled...
I have a feeling Kate's going to die.
Yeah. Where we rolled on that table for Timothy, which gave him +1 accuracy. That's because he had 3 courage.
Right. Yeah. As he gets more courage, he gets more skills. So, how about Kate take us forward one more?
I don't know what that involves.
Onto the board.
Just means read this card.
Sure.
Each survivors have to take in turn advancing on the board individually.
Random event.
Ooh.
Roll a d100 on the hunt event table.
Roll that.
Ah, so that was when you said that the white is our
read it
front
first,
number,
yeah.
So 87.
Bingo. Okay, and then what else did you say?
That just says,
that's it.
Yeah. 87.
87, Weeping Faces. Water flows from the eyes of the surrounding stone faces, gathering in a small pool.
Sounds pretty.
Any survivor may consume from the pool, roll a d10. If they have 3+ understanding, add +2 to the roll. Insane survivors are Inconsolable, they lie on the ground sobbing heavily. If any survivor is insane, roll again on the hunt table event before moving on the hunt board.
I
think we all are, aren't we?
What does insane mean?
Insane is when you have 3 plus insanity.
Okay, so we're all insane. Glenn is insane.
Chris
is. Chris is not. Kate is insane.
Katie's.
And Timothy, what's
Kate's
his?
Well insane.
Okay, it's not rolling for each one. We only roll once. So does Chris want to roll on the table?
Chris is like, what the hell's wrong with you people? All right. Is it worth it?
Is Chris wounded?
No. Chris avoid. Yes, Chris is. Yes, he's got hand arm damage.
Okay, because on a 7 and 8, he can heal up. 9 plus, water is invigorating, gain plus 1 speed token.
Oh, that's pretty good.
4 to 6 is refreshing. 1 to 3 is suffer 1 brain event damage.
Oh. 1 brain event. He's got 1, so that would cancel. So he would survive that.
Yeah.
Sure. 7!
7, there we go. The water is clearer. It's clearer than most. You may heal up to 2 injury levels at any one hit location.
Everyone's coming up, Chris.
Yeah.
Starting off, just to tell him I don't want to be Chris, it'll start going his way.
All right.
Typical.
And then roll on the table one more time. What? Because we haven't seen survivors.
So the person whose turn it was, both of them?
Yep.
Yeah.
37.
Survivors are wholeheartedly lost in the unbroken darkness. Move the survivors 2 spaces back on the hunt board.
Nice. Is that good or not? I guess that we got a buffer.
In this case, I don't know. I don't know because as we move forward, we're not going to. What happens if we move onto a blank space? There must be something that happens.
Maybe that's
just roll it. Roll an event.
Yeah.
Number or something.
Yeah, possibly. Could be an iPad.
Can we? Yeah, I still have a lot to learn about this game. I don't know. Like, can we leave a hunt early?
Yes. You can abandon the hunt early, but that means you don't get anything. You still advance a year.
But do we get the item that we
already acquired?
Yes,
we would get that. Yeah, we would get that.
Yes, okay, if you move and there is no hunt event card to the next location, roll once on the hunt event table. Oops. Alright.
Yeah, so the cards are just a bonus for the
purpose.
First few turns.
Alright, so we gotta move forward. I will take Timothy forward again. And I'll roll on the table. 51. Survivors encounter a group of fleeing settlers. If the settlement has symposium and language, the survivors manage to crudely communicate.
No symposium.
No. If they do, archive the offering. Refugees fanatically share this mournful tale. Well, if we had Symposium, the AI deck, we could look at the top 5 cards and put them back in any order.
Mm-hmm. Cool. Just language? Does that give us anything?
No.
Okay. Then you get language right away automatically.
But they have to have both.
Yeah. Would you always have?
All right. Mm-hmm. So, who? Huh?
Gwen will take us forward.
Gwen?
Yeah.
Okay. Rolling on the table.
53.
Mask salesman. The survivors meet a traveling mask salesman on the road.
A masked salesman or a mask salesman?
Mask salesman.
Okay. Like that this.
He insists that he has a special wear to offer. Shuffle 1 copy of each mask gear from the mask maker's settlement location and draw 1 at random.
I find it strange that in these times, someone can still make a living selling masks.
Yeah.
Like, that's a profitable business venture. Masks! Everyone's just trying to survive, but no. Something's fishy about that guy. I don't trust him.
Where's the masks?
I don't buy his story, Shane. I don't trust him. Can we just kill him?
No, you can't kill him.
I think it's a safer option. Guarantees our security.
Alright, so these are the mask cards. And it was who, sorry, who was?
Gwen.
Gwen? The item.
Ooh, it looks nasty. Antelope mask. Item, mask, bone, other. Unique, irreplaceable, accessory. At the start of your act, if insane, gain plus one movement.
All right, so now roll
what?
One,
what's this?
A d10.
I have to have like two red items and two blue things? How does that work?
I will have to look that up if we actually get it.
Yeah. So, yeah, what,
roll the d10.
Seven.
Roll seven. Salesman slowly gestures for an offering. Archive one gear of your choice from your gear grid.
Bye bye belt.
Belt is now gone. The term archive means it goes back to the game box.
Oh, wrong character. There.
So, Chris, if you ever hear archive,
it means put it in the box. Yeah.
I got that.
You lose it. It's gone.
I got that.
No.
As opposed to that, they just keep recirculating, and then we shuffle them every now and then?
Every time you go back to the settlement, yeah, all the cards kind of go back in a pile, so you regear each time.
So is insanity a good thing or not?
It's a good thing.
It's a good thing, but a bad thing.
So in this case, when we got to that, like, fountain of faces,
where Chris got
it was
to
bad.
Actually
yeah, because it meant all the people who were insane couldn't act.
But so Chris was stupid, but he got to benefit.
Yeah, so the way that insanity is good is that when you take brain damage in this game, it first removes your insanity. So when you take brain damage, the more insane you are, if you're insane and you take brain damage, it slowly heals your brain damage.
So are they essentially like our life points?
It's brain damage armor.
Yeah.
It's a weird one, but that's, it's insanity is brain damage armor, and sometimes it's bad for you.
Especially with the white lion, he does one of his attacks is like a roar, which everyone can scatter and they take brain damage. Or they take, basically they take a point of insanity away. So if you have no insanity, then you take a brain damage and then you take brain trauma. I'm not finding masks or equipment.
What do you mean? Why?
Just to find out what that means on the card there.
Oh, it doesn't matter. We certainly don't have it, so you can figure it out later.
But does it mean we can't use it?
No, it just means I don't get the, at the start of your act, get insane. Get plus one thing.
All right. So that's there.
All right, one more.
Now we just...
Now we just fight the lion.
Yep.
Yeah, okay.
Because he moves to us next turn.
No, he doesn't move unless something tells us that he moves, and nothing did. Yeah. So we're
you can get events or cards that actually move the lion further down the board.
All right.
Let's see if the board goes away.
And you gotta look up strategist.
Oh shit, what's happening? We're doing stuff.
Yeah.
Right now we go to the big board.
God board.
Goodbye, Kate. Yeah, you do need a large table, don't you?
Oh, actually, yeah. Do it this way again. So we got it.
This one. Like this? No. Leave it like this? Is that what you
mean? No, turn it.
Okay. This is fine.
So I should shuffle around?
No, I think this is fine.
Well, because then we can have
this right there.
Oh, we're going to throw it like this. Or...
There's Gwen. There's Chris. There's Kate. There's...
So you just place them randomly?
We're gonna
it starts by us.
Yeah. We have to be six places away from it, I think.
Okay.
I'm trying to plan.
And do any of our characters have any like special traits or abilities or anything?
So because she has Tourette's, the monster she's always a valid target for the monster. He always knows where she is. It doesn't mean she's always the target, it just means that amongst the choices he has, she's always one. And, who else? She also has the timeless eye, but because she's blind in one eye, she doesn't get the benefit for that. You have strategist ability, which we don't know what that does, so we don't look it up for you.
Okay.
It means you will get to like do some arrangement of the terrain on this board. Timothy, I don't think, has any special abilities like that. But your character, Kate and Timothy and Chris are our fighters.
Because I've got good eyes.
Yeah, you've got the bone blade, and Timothy's got the katar, and that makes...
But can we use the katar yet? Or
If we have two, then we get a bonus. Then you get a big bonus, yeah.
Okay.
Basically, you can use them both at the same time.
Okay.
Which is really good.
Yeah.
Strategist. I'm not finding that. Where? How would you get the power?
It's a fighting art.
Yeah. Oh, okay. So I need to...
You ever seen this game, Jake?
Tokyo 42, no?
Yeah. It's kind of like puzzly syndicate.
Puzzly syndicate?
Yeah, do you remember Syndicate?
Oh yeah, of course.
Yeah, so it's sort of like that. It's that very, very isometric, like that game, and you go in and out of buildings and stuff, and you're like this assassin, and you have to figure out how, there'll be like some dude on the map, and you have to like figure out how to do it.
Strategist. During the showdown setup, after placing terrain, you may add a giant stone face or top of pillar terrain card to the showdown board.
So, can we see what those do?
Yep. Alright.
Sounds like cover, which is probably a good thing.
Which I would have to assume would be... That would probably be the pillar.
Who has the strategist?
I do.
Okay, so those are what you get to choose from.
And giant stone face. Hello. Oh, very temple-y.
Yeah, no, Syndicate is another game that I think they could... Didn't they try to redo
They made a 3D version of it.
But no, they should have done another nice little... Like similar style, just yet again updated, not make it 3D.
Yeah. It's first person. Shouldn't have made it first person.
Yeah.
Yeah. And there's a game called Satellite Rain, which is basically that.
Ooh. So what does the debris give us?
The debris, you can search it. Roll a d10, and if you have a scavenger kit, which none of us do, you get +3 result. So you can get knocked down, you find nothing. You find useful random resource, you get a bone blade, you get scrap sword. Holy. So those are the things that can happen there.
Yeah, so we have to start within 6.
Yeah, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You can put debris side by side like that.
Well, it just says and any edge. Put them on any edge.
Okay, yep. Yeah.
So I suggest that we kind of like stick over to this side. You could maybe... Start over here?
No, I want to start here.
Here?
Yeah.
Okay.
Who's our tank?
Our tank, our Chris and Kate are our tanks. Tanks, as in they have the vest and the rawhide.
And it was Gwen who had the.
Gwen has the harp. And,
no, she has the auto.
The
auto draw.
I have Kate.
Auto draw.
Kate has.
Yeah,
the
where she draws the enemy.
Oh. So she yeah. Gwen has the Tourette's. It's not auto draw, it's just she's always eligible to target.
Yeah.
You need to back up one. If you want, we could do this there.
Yeah.
And when do I get to put these down?
Now.
You got one or the other.
Oh, yeah, one or the other?
Yeah.
Okay, well...
What do they do?
Okay, so the giant stone face is going to... It blocks survivor and monster's field of view, mm-hmm. interrupts ranged weapon attacks and monster targeting,
mm-hmm.
which I think they both have
so,
that.
Yeah, so that's a good thing. If one of us gets mauled and we need to escape, we can help
which,
them. Yeah.
Either way, I think we should put one of them at the back as a fallback.
Sure. Is there any reason why we wouldn't? Okay, so we want to get in the space of the giant stone. Their ranged weapons get +2 range and +2 accuracy. Oh. We don't have any range weapons.
So everyone, I do believe, should be at 2 survival. I think we have enough stuff that gives us...
Do we gain survival? I'm on 1.
Oh, weird. So you can spend an action to jump over this thing from here to here. I don't know why you would do that, but you could do that.
Is it block?
Hmm?
Is it block or anything?
Well, impassable. Oh, okay. You can't... Yeah, okay. So, yeah. You have to walk around it, or you can spend your action to flip over it. That's what it is. And this thing here, you can spend an action to jump up on top of it, and then you get accuracy and range bonuses.
And it has to be set up 5 away from the monster.
Okay. Yeah, same. Oh no, this gets set up 5 away from all boarded.
Which is...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you could stick it right here.
Nope. Stone face.
Well, that's...
No, that's because the stone face has to be 5 from
the
edge.
Why, so 5 away from the monster.
That's the only real one we can do, because that's the only one that makes
the
bacteria.
Yeah. But the stone face is, yeah.
Unless we wanted to place the stone face like over here or something, because that's the only part that's going
to
be...
This would need to be where we're standing. This is 4, this is 4 away from the monster? 1, 2, 3, 4, is that 5 away from the monster?
Yep.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
I think that's pretty good.
Except what's her name?
I think we should put it. I suggest you can leave it there if you want. I suggest we move it somewhere over here. We want to be able to like rush up and attack the well, he's gonna come.
It
to
has
us.
To be 5 away from
he's
the
gonna
it
come
has
to
be,
us.
We can't.
Yeah, yeah, but we could put it over. We could put it over here somewhere.
But
I mean, it's still on the board.
It's gonna take a long time for us to get around to it if we need it.
We won't need it right away. Right now, it does potentially block us from attacking the lion if it doesn't move or something. But we can leave it there. We'll figure it out.
Wait, who has the bone dart?
Nobody. We didn't make one.
What?
Yeah.
We still took one bone dart.
No. We made the guitar and the harp.
Denied again.
Yeah.
We need range.
Yeah.
We've been great with range right here.
It's one roll.
Always one range.
It's just one roll. It's not good. Well, actually, with this, it actually now is very... Because of the +2 accuracy, that's worth it. So
did you not have that strategist ability
we
last time
it.
You went out?
We
right.
got it, yeah.
So we're going with that?
Yeah. Well, so now,
go back.
Face is range multiplier. Beneficiary.
Alright, so yeah, make sure we have enough items for everyone to have 2 survival, correct?
Oh, okay. So, does everyone have... No, we don't have enough items for everyone to have 2 survival. Everyone gets 1 for leaving, and then she gets 1 for arriving, he gets 1 for arriving,
yeah.
He gets 1 for arriving.
So we got
Timothy,
one.
Timothy only has 1.
Ah.
Timothy already started out with 1.
If you already, then he's fine.
But he also, when you depart, you gain +1 survival, and the harp gives everyone...
Oh.
Doesn't it?
Yes, yeah, that's right. Yeah, we all have +2 because of the harp. That's right.
Yeah.
But also, if you have the noses, you get +1 insanity.
Yeah.
So
basically, if you take a look at our settlement, it has a survival cap. So even though we have stuff that could have given us more, you can only have maximum.
Yeah. As our community gets bigger, it allows our characters to have more survival than they get. But then we also have to have ways that they can actually generate that survival. So
what's a high number of survival at the moment?
2.
Okay.
2 is the max.
All right.
Yeah. Oh, 2 is current. Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So when I was on 1 before, it wasn't really that far behind.
No.
So now to build the AI deck. The AI deck is not only tells us what the monster does, it's kind of also the hit points.
Yeah.
So every time you damage it, an AI card gets pulled unrevealed out of the deck. Mm-hmm. It gets put down, and when it has no more AI, you need one more hit to kill it.
Yeah. Okay. So, how many? 5? 6? Or 10?
This is 10.
10.
So, basically 11 health.
We need to do 11 points of damage to the basic.
Okay.
So, getting all the basics.
To combat, your bone sword there, it's got that little oval thing on it.
Yep.
If the first number is speed, that's how many
the
dice.
Number?
Yeah. That's how many dice you get to roll. How many basically attacks you make.
Okay.
The next number is the number you need to roll to hit.
Okay.
And then the last number.
These are all day 10?
Yes.
Yep.
And then the last number is you roll a d10 and add that number, and that's sort of the strength of your hit, and you need to get over a number that the monster has.
Okay.
Depending on its
toughness. He's defend.
Okay. Yeah. And if you do that,
then you've
wounded it. You draw a hit location, you've done damage to it. You draw a hit location card and look at it, and it'll tell you where you hit it and stuff like that. Those cards will also have like a reaction from the monster. So sometimes the monster will react if you wound it. Sometimes it will react if you don't wound it, and sometimes it will react regardless of it. In the case of the white lion, it often leaps over the, like, it'll jump over 4 spaces and land and grab people and push them to the ground and maul them on the ground.
Because
it in the butt, and it'll kill another one of us.
Because of these cards, that's how many basic cards there are, and you only choose 7. So there's still another 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
These
so
are
like 13 different options.
For what the lion does. These are all of them? Or there's more?
Those are just the basics.
Oh, okay.
Now I'm just shuffling up the advanced.
So we nearly have to do every single one, basically, is what you're saying?
Or no, it's half the basic cards. So
each critter in the game comes with a deck of all of its brain cards, and each time you fight it, you're not going to play all of them, just some of them. So the last lion we fought, we had like an idea of like, well, it used to do these moves. This one might do something different because we haven't seen it yet.
Yeah, those are the events.
This is something that we haven't seen in the game yet, is mood. The creatures can be in a particular mood, and like the harp we have here, I can use that to like remove the mood. We don't know what that is yet. Sounds bad.
It's not going to be good.
Yeah.
If the rest of the entire game is anything to go by, it's not going to be like, oh, you guys are friends.
Yeah.
So there's a
feeling passive
look.
There.
He wanted to discuss what your backgrounds were.
Yeah.
And why were we enemies.
How did we get here? All right. So.
Line, where's.
Basically, there, yeah. So when the lion attacks us, each of his brain cards here will have a different kind of attack, but if he just uses his basic attack, the first thing he has to do is pick one a target, and anybody he can see in this like cone in front of him is they're the first eligible targets.
Yep.
And if there's nobody there, then he smells the air around us, and anybody within like an area around it becomes a possible target, and he'll like move up to 6 spaces and attack that person. He rolls 2 dice, he needs 2s or more to hit us, and he does 1 damage when he hits us.
And Gwen, because she's got Tourette's.
Gwen's always an option. So even if he can't see anybody in front here, he's like, oh, yeah.
There's Gwen.
Yeah.
There's also ability that when you're in the grass,
you
can spend one of your actions.
Oh, and hide.
And hide.
Yeah.
So for argument's sake, shouldn't we have all started purposely away from Gwen?
No,
if he has like an area of attack.
We need them to be close to the lion. We want to get up and kill the lion.
Okay.
So she's actually useful because if we need to, we can be like, this guy we don't want her to attack Timothy. He's got a great weapon and stuff like that. So
and if Timothy goes down, we lose all the items, don't
we? We don't lose them. We lose them for the fight.
Okay.
But after the fight, we collect them all again. What was I gonna say? Something about. Oh, it's gone now. Look at that.
Whenever you hit the monster, you draw one of these cards to determine where you hit it.
It'll tell us where how
and
it reacts.
Reactions.
Yeah.
Alright, so. Are we gonna have her there? Because she would be.
Yeah, well, I. I don't.
Sure. No.
Yeah.
She's in the. Oh no, it's front arc from there.
Yeah. Right. Okay. She's still visible to him though.
Okay. But if that says that it covered, but then the Tourette's overplays the person's hidden.
I don't know what the lion will do in that case, right?
Because like, does the Tourette's have to be line
there,
of sight,
but he can't make it to her.
So that overrules line of sight because it's like an audible.
It's noisy. Yeah. Okay.
All right. So now we go with the first turn.
Yeah. The lion goes.
Yep. Lion goes.
But I don't know what he does because
draw the AI.
He would attempt
to move.
Sure. Yeah. 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 It will depend on what the AI is. So you need the monster card. I'll see first. So size up. Pick a target. Random threat in field of view. So
Gwen it is?
It's Gwen because
by default.
The noise. Yeah. The monster stares down its prey. No. I'll say it's just peeking over them. It's calling. Turn to face the target. Roll a d10. On a result of 4, the target suffers 1 brain damage per monster level and is knocked down. Yep. So she's knocked down. She suffers 1 point of brain damage, but that's fine.
So what knockdown means is at the end of the next monster's go, she can stand up.
At the end of the next monster's... Yeah.
Okay, so can there be multiple monsters on the table at once?
We've never seen that.
I don't think so.
It sounds like a possibility.
Well, there could be like a big monster in the hip and like little things. I think I've seen that. Maybe, yeah.
Sounds like it.
Maybe. So then that's it. That's it done. He's done.
Alright.
Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. The lion has a blind spot behind him. And if you can fight it while you're in these squares, you get an extra chance, +1 to hit. So you want to be behind it.
Five.
And where is our movement?
Possibly.
You look at
primary stats.
Oh. It's just kind of light there.
Oh yeah. It's pre-printed on the card ring.
Okay, so we all have a standard 5.
Yeah, 5. Yeah.
Okay.
So, I guess this is where you could write that +1 evasion right there if you want.
Yeah, that's where you would write it.
Yeah. Yeah.
The evasion's coming from...
So there's permanent bonuses, and then there's called tokens, and that's what is in the box. Tokens only last for the battle.
Okay.
Yuki.
Alright, you going?
Yeah, I'll go.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So yeah, you can do a move action and a regular action.
In any order.
But you can't split up your move action. You can't go 1, 2, do something.
Yep.
So I go in there. I have the guitars. I have +1 accuracy. So I'm hitting on...
sixes.
With 3 dice.
You have the +1 speed?
+1 accuracy.
So what? Oh, the guitar is 3 or 2? I thought it was just 2. Speed.
Oh, it's damage 3.
Yeah,
right.
Strength 3.
So hitting on 6s.
One hit.
Damage location. Haha! Is it reflex?
So it's going to do this regardless of what you did, which is good because that's what we wanted it to do.
If you take a look in the card here, it's a reflex. There's 3 different types. There's reflex,
wound, and fail.
Fail, yeah. Reflex, it does whatever. Wound, it will do if you wound it. Fail, if you fail to wound it, it does it.
Yeah.
So this is no matter what, it's going to move forward. Okay. Since it can't move past that, it'll also smack into that,
yeah.
Which is kind of good.
Wait, so what was the actual...
So you hit it in...
So that's what he does. It moves
that's
the...
That's what he does, yeah.
Okay.
Now Shane's going to roll to see if he does critical damage.
Yeah.
Well, you have to roll to wound it, and then and as a chance to do critical damage.
Wait, so is the lion moving or not?
Yeah, it will move. So he hits it. He's gonna roll to see if he does damage to it. And then after that, the thing is it's gonna move forward.
So this has a special ability called a deadly, which gives plus one luck to the weapon, which means criticals are now on a 9 or a 10.
Yeah, normally if you roll a 10 when rolling to wound, it's critical. But these will critical on
which
a 9 or
on
10.
On the dice will be below Latrin.
Yeah.
Or a 0.
So the lion's toughness is 6, and the strength is 3.
Well, that was 8, level 1.
Oh, I'm looking at the you're right, 8. So
8?
You need,
I have 3?
You need 5s. Yeah, 5s to wound it, and if he rolls a 9 or a 10, it's a critical hit.
Which then...
Yeah, does something special.
That is
close. That's okay though. So he did one damage. That's 1 point of damage into the damage of the monster. And then I think.
And then it moves forward.
Oh yeah. Kate should go.
Yeah, I'm just gonna move this. Oh yeah,
run
up I can
here
go
here and backstab it.
5. That is what Kate's gonna do when it's Kate's turn.
When moving, it's either like.
You don't
forward or side, there's no diagonal.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay, is that the end of a turn then?
That's fine. Yeah.
He's
so
done, so Kate can go now.
So when the animal moves, it's the end of your turn?
No. the animal just got like sort of a move in the middle of his turn just now. That's
okay.
It. Yeah.
Okay.
So you can go.
And your turn's over?
Yep.
Okay, so that's what I want to do with Kate. I want to move Kate around to one of the attack bonus squares.
So you would roll your 2 dice for the bone sword. You need a, what's it, 6? A 6 to hit, but because
plus
you're in the rear of it, you need a you get plus 1, 5.
So
either dice gets a 5, that's a hit. If you got 5s on both of them, it's 2 hits.
Two hits.
So
yeah, so 5 or above.
That's right.
Yes. Not an actual 5.
Yeah, that's right. So you're going to get 2 of these. You can flip them over and look at both of them, and then decide the order in which they you do them in. And you'll see why that might matter in a minute.
So, and should I?
Obviously, we should share
with everyone. It's not something you keep yourselves.
Okay. So, this one happens if you fail. He'll jump back. And this one, nothing happens. So, do this one first. Because if you fail, nothing happens. And then
the next one. So, roll 1d10.
No, not yet. So, first, now you've hit him, and now you need to see if it's critical or a wound.
Okay.
So you roll a d10 and add 2.
So the bottom?
Yeah. And you need to get a total of 8.
One dice?
One dice.
And I need a...
So you got 9 plus 2 is 11, and you needed an 8, which is great.
Okay, so what do I need an 8
from? He doesn't have lucky anywhere?
He doesn't have luck.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
So
I'm not cut out for this.
You wounded it. But you didn't do a critical hit.
Okay.
So we don't need to read any more of the card.
Yeah.
But you did a wound, so we put that over there. Now we do this one. If you fail to wound, you're gonna do this.
Yep.
That's it. So roll that die. Roll it, add 2.
5, 6, 7.
So we're sure.
You needed an 8, so you failed. So now we do this.
White line jumps back. Without moving the monster one space. Move the monster one space directly away from the attack. Cancel all unresolved hits now out of range.
So,
like this?
Away from the attack.
I said away from the attack, but I can't go past the possible. That would be impossible.
So that's it?
That's it.
Okay.
Locked out.
And then you've done your move, you've done your attack, that's the end of your turn.
We're backed into a corner.
So then, Chris will go. Chris? Will not spend his action to or survival to wake Gwen up. She's just gonna get up on her own because she's not gonna attack the creature.
1, 2, 4.
Yeah, it's too early. 3, 4. He'll go here. He'll use his bone sword. Need 6s. Miss. So that's the end of the turn. Yeah, Gwen will get up at the end of the monster's next turn. Sorry.
Yeah, after the monster goes, then she stands up.
Yeah. So
you can now see the starting lion is a little bit weaker than the one we're fighting now.
Oh, okay.
But you can kind of see that when all you have is a cloth waist armor and a stone rock.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's going to take some time.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a little scary.
Yeah. The little stone rocks you get.
come with a special ability though, which is really strong.
Oh, did you target UN Survivor?
No.
No.
Yeah. Okay. It.
What?
You read on there.
So,
this gets passed around. So now I'm the monster controller. So if I get a choice of who I get to choose from, and I choose my own survivor, I get plus one insanity.
Yeah. If the monster targets one of your own character, that character gets more insane. Which is a good thing. Sort of.
Yeah, so we sort of established that number's a good thing.
Sort of. Yeah. Okay.
Alright. So give me an AI. Closest threat, facing in range.
She's in facing.
Does that block view at all?
Impassable. Obstacle blocks survivor and monster field of view.
Ah, here we go. It
blocks monster targeting.
If adjacent to the top of pillar, always on one of its long sides, we're going to consider that front.
Yep.
You may hop over it. Place your survivor in the corresponding space.
So that's survivor, not monster.
Yeah.
Would that apply though? If we're sort of, for argument's sake, that is now the character we're controlling.
If it was executing this little if you see here, at the start of your act, you gain plus one move and plus one activation. That little lightning bolt is your activation, and you can spend that to do a bunch of stuff. One of them you can spend it to do is this.
Oh, because and the items have some of your items.
Yeah,
have.
We'll have little things like that.
Okay.
But the lion doesn't get one of those, so he's not spending that. It's not. He's just doing what's on his card.
Okay.
So.
Well, that's fine. Wouldn't Kate do that?
So he'll move. He'll try and move to get to her.
I thought you said it blocks.
But she's always, her gear is noisy, which means it is, she's always an eligible target. So, he's collecting targets, she's one, she's the only one, so that's the target that he chooses. And now he has to move to attack her.
Yeah, so that would be move to 6.
Yep. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
yep.
I guess. Sure.
Nice.
Yeah,
that actually worked out.
That's a very good result.
She stands up.
That is a very good result.
Yeah,
except Timothy or Slash Monster is too far away.
He's a little way, but
we can work around that though.
Yeah,
Tim.
Call me Tim. All right, Monty Python and the Holy Grail.
We talked about this. I haven't watched.
Oh,
okay.
Definitely watch it.
There's an
enchanter.
I need to see.
He comes and he's blowing up all the stuff all over the place, and he's like, "And some call me Tim. Tim the enchanter."
Who's gonna go first? Kate can go first.
Kate just went, didn't she? Oh, just each round and all stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, I vote. Can we just decide?
Yeah.
Or is that like an unfair advantage?
Nope.
Let's.
The reason I suggest you go first is
we should let.
Oh, wait. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I think we should send Gwen first. Because then we can position Gwen in closer. Because she. Oh, no, she's not gonna make it anyway. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You're the only character that can actually get into. Well, she can fight it as
but
well.
But Gwen can as well.
Is Gwen. Or sorry, this is Gwen.
Oh, wait,
this is you. This is Kate.
Oh, no, that one.
This is.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah.
Chris.
Well, let's send her in first, because then she can get to there, and then he can get to there, can't he?
I think she can only get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. She can only get to here.
Oh, we get 5, but I get 6.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Well, let's do that then.
She's the only one that can fight it.
Let's send her there.
Okay.
We know she's gonna end up there.
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna. Just attack it.
Yep.
And I get the plus one to the number that I roll with this.
Yep. So you roll, two dice, because the speed is 2. First number is 2. So you throw 2 dice.
Okay. Then, so that's about right.
Yeah.
Okay.
You got 2 hits?
1.
No, it's a plus 1 for the rear, and she needs 6s.
That's 2 hits?
Yep. So.
Okay. And these are the ones that I look at and we do in any order. Okay.
So.
Failure and a wound?
So this one triggers off a fail, and this one triggers off a wound. What does it do? Oh, okay. So this one is, if you wound it and your character understands well, then you understand that the cracking sound you heard is its ribs getting broken, and you feel encouraged.
Right.
So this one, if you fail, he will attack you back. So I suggest you do this one first, and then this one.
Okay. So and is this
So now you're rolling the dice and adding that bottom number.
One or two? Two, because
one, well, you'll do them in one. You'll do them in each order.
Okay, and so, I add two to the number.
That's right.
And I wait. And, what do I need?
You're trying to get an eight.
And where does the eight come from again?
His toughness.
Okay, so it always comes back to eight because of the monster we're fighting. Yep. Because of the monster we're fighting.
Yeah. Yeah.
His stats are
okay. Yeah. Okay.
Person's movement.
Toughness. Yeah, toughness is eight.
Yeah.
Because we're
yeah.
level one. Because we're you guys have already done it before.
But yeah,
We chose to hunt a level one lion. We could we could hunt like a tougher lion, but
okay. Okay. Seven plus one.
Plus two.
Plus
for
two.
For your weapon, there's the bottom number is a strength. So okay. You got a nine. So you wounded it, but it wasn't a critical wound. But that's also fine though. So you to critical wound it, you would have needed a 10. The like lantern symbol.
Good. So and then roll the other one for failure. So
yeah. Oh, you also because you wounded it. If your understanding had been three or more,
yeah, which we didn't
you
have.
Would have. Yeah.
Okay. So one more.
Yeah. But you also
nine.
Wounded it. And he's not lucky to see that. That's the second nine you rolled. You did not fail. So the monster does not attack you.
Just end of turn.
And you do another point of damage to it.
Sweet. Good result.
The one, what does it do on a wound?
If you wound it, you hear the sounds of its cracking ribs, and it sounds encouraging.
Oh, right. you said you were hungry. I have options. I got chips.
I'll eat anything at this point.
I also have chocolate-covered raisins there.
I have chocolate, but thank you.
I got cashews.
Ooh.
I also have...
D, all of the above, except chocolate.
Yeah. Oh, I can come in here and...
What sort of chips you got?
Like, open, I got salt vinegar and I have cheese and everything.
Costco.
That's what you told me. That's first. Alright, and then, or I also have Rice Krispies. I'm actually gonna take that.
Yeah, you get a ball or anything? I was gonna take that.
Thank you, sir. Good result.
Now I'm gonna be all salty though on the car.
I got water.
I meant for the card, we don't really need to touch anything. Sweet. Thank you, sir. Chip?
I'll be.
Okay. Perfect. Yeah. There. I'm going to put them under the table there. Sure. They're close by you if you want them. Also, thank you.
Alright, so...
So,
now,
so I don't know what we want these guys to do, if they want to come this way or this way. Maybe they want to kind of move into the grass over here. Gwen can, like, search one of these things.
Yeah.
She could try and go around up and attack it. Her chance of hitting it is really bad, though. Like, she needs...
Get her to search the debris then.
Yeah. Why don't we get her to move one more away first with a move square, like move to the further one away? So she's further away from the lion. Assuming the lion's going to keep chasing her though, because if the lion gets six movement.
If she's here, then the lion will move up to here, and other characters can move up and then move around and attack it, maybe. If she's here, it'll get deeper into the hole. I'm not sure.
Either way.
Yeah,
either way. Okay.
Not
so,
sure much news.
I'll go to the farmer. And where is that? That's over here. Debris.
If you want something to drink, I got water, ginger ale.
Thank you.
I find rare gear. I gain one scrap sword gear. Get me a scrap sword gear.
Gwen's coming through.
Yeah.
I'll be honest, I'd written her off as...
Yeah.
Contributing anything useful to the group.
Last time we played, we were doing really well in the beginning, and then everything kind of went to hell.
Yeah,
I bet it started with Gwen.
Gary got chest wounds, and Gwen lost an eye.
Oh.
So
yeah.
What'd you get?
Oh, I forget that she's
sword.
Got one eye.
Yeah.
Poor Gwen.
Yeah.
I want to go over and, like, be a...
Give her a hug?
Yeah, be a bodyguard for her. That's what I'm doing. I've decided it. That's going to set the tone for the rest of my game. Protect Gwen at all costs.
I don't see scrap swords.
She's wearing this really freaky antelope mask right now as well. One scrap sword gear card.
Adventure sword, steel shield, steel sword, twilight sword.
Those all sound too good.
That's under rare gear.
Oh, I don't think it's a rare gear. It just says you find rare gear. Gain one scrap sword. So I don't think it's like actually rare. Just
there we go. Yeah.
Oh, is it an actual sword?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh.
So, on a perfect hit, the edge sharpens. Gain +4 strength for the rest of the attack.
Hmm. What's a perfect hit?
That's your crit. That's your
okay.
10.
Okay. Gains deadly if I have two red and a blue item. She's just got one blue item.
Yeah. I think that mask, all you have to do is have two red, two blue. I don't think it has to be
yeah,
looked up.
Yeah, yeah, that sounds right. Yeah.
Looks like it.
So would this be, this is two red. This would be a blue. That would be two red and two blue. Blue, blue, red, red.
I'll look it up.
Yeah. Okay. Anyway, so she's got right, this.
So Timothy is going to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, so Gwen gets.
And holy up.
Gwen got a good weapon.
Yeah, so the, she did the action, so she actually gets it. We can't just DP it up.
After this, there's no rules I've seen yet about trading during a battle. But after the battle, all this stuff goes back into a pool, and we you know, re...
No, I'm not going to jump over. I'm just going to move to there.
Okay.
Because it's going to go after her. It's going to probably batter around a little bit. And now we just need...
Back one for the team, Gwen.
Chris, so... I could come... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I could come here in hopes that it comes in here and then we can circle around behind it.
Oh, it'll go in there.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, so I'll be ready to do that. So I'm just going to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That. So then you've got the awesome
yep.
card.
So that's it. Now pass it to Chris.
Yep.
So draw his AI card.
Here's what the monster does. Claw.
Closest threat facing
in
range.
So he can see her, so he moves up to her and attacks her with his claw.
And speed 2, accuracy 2 plus.
Yeah, so it's just it's basically a basic attack. Sorry, Gwen. Roll 2 dice. And if you get 2s or more, which you got on both of them, now roll 2 of the cubes, the regular dice with the weird locations.
So
you hit her in the foot, and you hit her in the body. So Gwen takes 1 leg scratch and 1, she's got light damage to her body and her leg. And now it's our turn.
So AI card goes away.
Goes away.
So that, is the AI like his hit points or is that
so
the,
this is
the other
this
file?
Is these are AI cards we've removed from him.
Yep.
These are his AI cards that we don't know what he's got yet. These are the ones that he's revealed. When this is empty, we put all these back there.
Oh, okay. So the other one is like the hit points.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, and have we got any of, we got rid of any of those?
Well, yeah, you did most of this. We've done 4 points of damage so far.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. So, but it's just, they just go into the same pile.
Yeah, they all just get into the wound stack.
Okay.
Yeah. This is his AI. This is his discard. When this is empty, we put these back. We just like reshuffle it and put them back. And then as we do damage, we move it to the wound.
Okay. I do not want to talk to
you. Sorry. All right.
Need to know basics. That's not my part.
Who's gonna go? I think that because we do know he does like the often wounds will trigger the pounce, and so if he did that, he would pounce Gwen. I don't really want that. So I could just run her out of there, get her away, and then these two characters can come in and get the back attacks on him.
Could I go first for this round in the hopes that it would have a reflex and attack me? Try and draw it away from Gwen.
So it's just as likely that it'll reflex and attack you as it is that it'll leap forward and grab Gwen and Maul.
Okay.
So I think she should just clear. And then the other two characters can get in there.
All right. Then yeah. Timothy's going to take the heat.
Possibly. Well, if he leaps, he'll leap over here and just miss him. So that's okay.
So is there a high chance he's going to leap?
It's,
don't know.
It's a common result.
But you guys know it's coming because you've played the round.
Yeah, yeah. Well, he did it a minute ago, right? Like when what's her name attacked.
That's what we're saying. Yeah. We chose 7 basic cards out of a pile of 17. Of a pile of 13.
Yeah.
And then the advanced cards, there's 10, and we chose 3.
Yeah. So we haven't seen all of these actions.
Okay, so that could be it.
Yeah. But we do. A bunch of them have had that leap ability. Okay. So do you... You want to try and go in and chop on him again?
I'd say go in with, Chris first.
Okay.
Because he's going to take more movement.
I can't get past him.
Yeah, it's going to take too much.
I thought you can pass through your own guys.
Can you?
As long as you don't stop.
Oh! Gwen should have attacked. Oh, no. Yeah, Gwen should have attacked first. I should have taken the risk and attacked first. Real well.
Okay. Yeah, then you can move out of the way afterwards. No, you can move through your own guys. Okay. You just can't, if you stop,
two, three, four,
it's a collision.
Five. All right. Come on, Chris.
Go, Chris.
Just using the bone swords. You need sixes, you need fives. One hit. Yeah. So if I fail to wound, he's going to do the leap.
Which would have got Gwen. Yeah. All right, well, but it would have been past Gwen, wouldn't it?
Hey, it leaps over her, grabs her, throws her on the ground, and mauls her on the ground.
Oh, so anyone in that?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah, that's right. So the roll to wound, I need a six or more. No, failed wound, so.
Here it goes.
One, two, three, four, and he lands over here. All right, Timothy, you're up. Show us what that thing can do.
I'm just double checking for the movement.
For going through each other?
Yeah. Oh, okay. They cannot voluntarily pass through spaces occupied by monsters or other survivors.
Oh, okay.
So it would have had to have been her first.
Okay.
Wow. So we can't go through?
We can't walk through each other, yeah.
Okay. Only around.
Yeah. I would
be from behind.
I would stick one tile over. Because no one else is going to go in there. You might as well be closer to the middle of the ward. Closer to the grass.
If it doesn't move for some reason?
Okay.
Guitars. Hitting on
fives.
So behind plus one accuracy.
One hit.
Failure. There's an option. Would perform a basic attack against me. Otherwise, critical wound. Cut off its hand. Alright.
You need a five. Come on.
I need a 5 plus.
Yeah.
Does he have
9, 10?
Does he have strength? He does, doesn't he?
Him, no.
Oh, okay. Okay. His items don't.
Nice. Yeah!
Okay.
That's really critical wound. Cancel R in this card. Good. You hack off the monster's hand. Spend one survival to treasure this moment and gain one plus permanent strength. I'm spending the survival.
Sweet. Can we get a hand? No. But persistent injury, he has lost hand. That goes over here.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna cover up the debris. Okay, sweet.
Next. Good
deal. Next.
Let's move Kate.
Okay.
Do you want to do something? Or
nope. That's good. I think you're the only one left to go anyway.
Yep.
So
I think we should move her down this direction, assuming.
Here?
How many have we got?
You can go to there.
Yeah, I'd rather come over here.
Yeah, it's going to attack.
Because if it attacks Gwen, it's going to go straight on, which is going to bring.
Yeah, it's going to attack one.
And then I can, on the next turn, if it's over here somewhere, then I can sneak around and try and get to it.
Okay.
Unless some weird thing where it attacks something directly behind it.
Yeah.
Then that's going to
claw. So, yep, pick a target. This is going to go 1, 2, 3. Miss. And a hit. Hits her in the hand, which has no damage yet. So
does the monster get critical hits or not?
This creature only does one damage usually per attack. So that means we each time it hits us, it does light damage and then heavy damage, and then once we were going past heavy damage, everything is a critical hit at that point. And you roll on this chart, and bad stuff will happen. You're like, oh, your arm got ripped off, or. So that's it? That's it for him?
That's it.
Yep. And now,
I think Kimothy should go.
Gwen should go. Rip around behind him. He could possibly leap into the wall.
Yeah, Timothy, that back attack in case.
Well, but Timothy will get to back attack after, like, if he leaps, he'll still get to back attack. But if he does right. leap, then Gwen will get attacked. That's my plan. You good with that?
You know, okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. I just hope it doesn't turn around and run away. We lose everything.
He won't run that way. Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I mean, if anything, he's going to go this way.
Hopefully.
He might turn around, which is still fine. So.
Wait, the monster can get away?
He can move.
He could move. Like just like when.
Then you miss out on your attack.
Yeah. I don't think he'll move.
You're not going to be the hero.
I don't think he'll move in a way that you won't get to attack.
Timothy was a hero from the very first battle. That's why Timothy is so great. He's the one out of nowhere, threw a rock.
That's why it's going to be devastating when he goes down.
I need 2 dice, 5 to hit.
My leaderless. Go on.
One hit.
You knock the lion's jaw off in the very first battle.
Pretty impressive.
Yeah. Beast's chest. If I fail, he's gonna leap. Yeah. And I need a. It's only 3, so I need 5. 9. That is. No, it's deadly? Not. It's not. It gains deadly if I have the stuff. Nope. So, not critical. It wounds it though. And that's a blast.
Yeah, card.
Now we know what the monster's gonna do. He's gonna size up, he's gonna bat around, he's gonna claw and claw.
Wait. So now Timothy's gonna go. 2, 4.
Chop, chop.
Rolls. Hitting on 5+. Two hits.
Two
hit locations.
1, 2.
We have a failure.
Oh, sorry, he's here. You're here. He left at the end of that. Oh, no, that's only if I failed.
I'd say stop smoking the drugs, then. No, you don't. Both these are failures. I think I'm going to do, if for some reason, only the damage. Otherwise, I take brain damage and knock down.
Okay.
I mean, it's a smaller chance because I have, I'm wounding it on 5s.
Yeah. Nice.
Is that crit?
Oh, it is.
Yeah. Your attack destroys the white lion's foot. It loses its leverage. The white lion gains -1 movement token.
Which one is it? This is the beast's paw? That's the one you hit?
Yep.
Okay. That's permanent.
Gain 1 white lion claw.
Oh, sweet. We made 2 guitars.
Broken foot. Ignore the effect of grab.
Hmm.
What a hero.
Yeah, so we got 2 claws.
Timothy.
This has been a successful hunt.
And for the second one. Oh, this is where I can knock the jaw.
Again?
Yeah.
2. Nope, failure. Monster roars triumphantly, roll a d10 on 4+. The attacker suffers 1 brain damage per monster level it's knocked down.
Oh no, Timothy, don't get brain damage. Done so much.
On roll 1. 3.
Woohoo! Does he face? No, he did roar.
On a 4+, yeah.
Does he face?
No.
Okay. Alright.
Well, you know, I just cut off his foot.
Yeah, and his hand. He's like lost his hand and his foot.
Which, if you see, front of the hand, the back of the foot.
He's got like human hands on his front. Yeah. Okay.
So while you've been doing the more damage, I've been doing more crits. Cutting pieces off.
You only have 3 left. Almost dead. Can you? 4, 5. Yeah, you can get in there and do damage.
Do you think I should? Or
I think
I should just run away and let's just play it safe. I run up to behind the pillar, then he's going to... Well, that's going to be everyone's turn, isn't it?
Yeah. The only reason that you would not attack him now is if we didn't want him to leap. But we don't care if he leaps, because he'll just bump into the wall.
Yeah, exactly. So there's no point in me taking a risk to take damage for no reason.
But the reason you take the risk is so that you can kill it. Like,
but we're going to kill it regardless next turn.
No.
Probably, yeah, because he's gonna leap forward, which, well, then at that point the two can walk forward and attack him with limited risk.
Well, it's the same risk.
That's limited risk, because if I'm over here,
yeah,
you got lots of armor.
What I mean, like,
what if I get brain damage or something?
It's the same risk of them attacking it as you attacking.
You got lots of insanity.
But wouldn't he go forward because I'm in the line of sight though? If I'm here, it's a strategic bait.
He'll go after. Well. You're trying to lure it over here because he can see you. What's the range of its sight?
It isn't limited.
It's like a cone. It's like this.
Because if I'm there, he's only got... He can't get to me. And it's going to come as far forward as the impassable pillar.
Yeah, it's possible.
And then those two are going to have... It's going to be the end of its turn. And those two have got an end.
They could move up and attack it. Yeah, it's possible it could be good. We'll check its vision range.
No point taking, like, if survivability is the key in this game.
We have to attack it though. Like,
yeah, we got to. Kate doesn't have to.
If you do, sure. There's no reason why it shouldn't be her versus someone else. That's all. Like,
facing is seven.
Seven?
Yeah.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So if you're here, he's gonna go one, two, three. Yeah, okay, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
Move here.
Because then she's safe, she doesn't get damaged.
Yeah.
Because if I attacked it and there was a reaction from it, like there's a risk of me having a negative effect.
But the same with like the next turn, then one of us is going to have to attack it.
But the risk is less because they have a bonus because they're attacking from behind.
Well, you've got the evasion though. These two characters have the armor that gives us like a better chance to not be hit.
This is
good though. I think we're good.
Alright, and then what's Chris gonna do?
He will go here, and he will look at this stuff. Three. You find nothing. So that's it. So you're now the monster controller, and he does this.
Bat around, choose closest threat. Is it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7? Yeah, she's in.
But she's also a threat, though.
Yeah. Yeah, true. That would override it, wouldn't it? Because isn't she the...
She'll be the closest threat.
Yeah.
But that's closest threat facing in range.
Yeah, but she's always an eligible target.
Oh, yeah, so it would turn on her.
Yeah,
I would agree.
So we didn't need to run.
Dang it! Well, the idea was there. Sorry, Tourette's girl. We tried.
Speed 2.
She's got survival, so she can survive this.
You can use survival to dodge one attack.
Yeah.
Which is an auto success. So accuracy 5+.
Oh, that's good.
Two hits?
No, that's not good.
I'm gonna take the first one.
Roll location.
First location.
Body. It'll go to heavy, I'll take it.
And you're knocked down?
Yes, that's right.
Because it goes to heavy?
Yeah.
For any location, area?
Hand. Any heavy, that's also heavy. Oh, no, that's the legs.
And...
If you take a look on there, I'll show you. Once marked heavy.
Yeah, it says, here. Heavy injury.
Okay, so that's sort of what you were saying before. Like, I've only got one light damage, the chances of me having...
You won't get killed. Yeah, you're not going to get killed. Oh, you could have. It could have hit you.
Catastrophic.
It could have hit you twice in the hand, both wounding. It would have gone to like heavy and knocked you down, and then the next one could have been like your hand is severed
dead.
And you bleed out.
And
since
both of them did damage, there's an after damage trigger, which you suffer brain damage equal to the monster's level.
Okay, that's fine. That's just making her more sane. Okay.
Twice. You have two hits.
Yeah, I did. So that happens every time? Or just like
full
after... If if she
the
hits
accuracy trigger after damage.
Yeah, so the first one only
moves. Oh yeah, okay, yeah, that's... Yeah, okay.
Alright. That's not everything, right? Don't move there, because he can get an attack. Move here if you're going to attack.
Ah, oh, it's so much better.
It's just as good for him too. We each get plus one.
Yeah, but I'm...
Shane wants to go for the win.
Yeah, he does. So don't.
Let him.
But my my attacks, because of that lucky...
One, two, three, four, five. Oh, I can attack from side too. Okay, yeah. That's fine.
It's just that lucky
it's
attack.
It's like I just didn't want us to not
get
one.
Yeah, that's actually better. That's actually better if you can still get to the side anyway.
Yeah. No, I knew you could get to the side.
I can count to five.
So
go Shane!
Five pluses. One hit. Hit location is... Oh. Ooh. Oh. So I become the priority target. If I wound it.
If you wound it.
Ooh!
You'll be fine.
But on a critical hit, the line is knocked down. So you can come in.
Yeah.
You could almost finish him in chain, couldn't you?
No, he won't finish it. But I mean, very close to that.
So wounding on five pluses, crits on nines.
I just realized this is a pencil one. I kept pressing the end.
Oh. So white line is knocked down?
Yeah. So does that mean his wound effect?
While monster's knocked down, all reactions are cancelled, and all hit rolls succeed on a 3+.
Well, that's pretty easy, isn't it?
Yeah, I suggest you... Oh, it doesn't matter, I can do it. Yeah, no, I've got two anyway. Yeah.
Oh. So, when
Chris will spend one survival to get Gwen to stand up again.
Oh, is that a Chris perk?
No, everyone has the encourage ability.
Oh, so any one of us can do that?
Yeah,
and it doesn't take an action.
Yeah.
Your action.
One,
movement.
Two, three, four, five. And then he attacks, he needs...
Three pluses.
Okay.
See?
Yeah.
Went in there, knocked it over.
No, that was good. I was thinking I couldn't get in on the side, but if more attacks was better than you getting a back attack with your extra criticals. But since he can attack, what we did was
two hits.
Two of these.
Is that
so? Reshuffle the hit location deck. Attacker is doomed. Perform a basic. Oh, but if the monster's knocked down. He gets up, I think. A trap cancels all the attacker's hits and ends their attack. When a trap is drawn, knockdown monster will stand.
But I'm also the priority target right now.
So that comes back?
Yeah, this is the worst. This is the I don't know. There's one of these in the deck, and if you draw it, it's shitty for you.
But that's just for the hit location. That's not really that detrimental.
It means that, like, I hit it twice. Because I do this, it cancels the other attack.
Yeah, that's not great.
Yeah. And then, my character's
anyway.
Doomed, and the cat makes an attack on him.
Oh. Bad luck, Chris.
Yeah. So, the cat.
Yeah, and so,
attack.
So that's the result of the card that Shane. That was a failure from Shane. No, that
no,
was.
No, he went up and wounded it, and then because he wounded it, the location he hit was. The cat was like faking being knocked down. He was like waiting, lying in wait.
Yeah, so it comes back though.
Yeah.
So, Shane. Okay.
So, he gets two hits on him. Belt in hand, Chris. Belt has armor. Hand takes a light hit. And that's... Was I knocked down? I forgot to check if I was knocked down. I think I'm just hit.
No, I think you are knocked down.
I think you're knocked down on the... Oh, okay. I can't remember.
When trap is drawn, a knockdown monster will stand. After the trap is formed, we shuffle all. Nope, not knocked down.
Okay. Alright. Then.
Yeah, here's a weird thing.
Because I have priority target.
Yeah.
Well, your character is always a target.
I'm not always the target. I'm just an option.
Yeah.
I'm just always an
potential.
Option. Okay.
Yeah. So I think that would still make it focused on you.
You could move up. Doesn't.
Has Gwen had a turn?
Gwen will go. Gwen could go now.
I think Gwen should go and try and kill it.
Okay.
Go for the big victory hurrah.
4 or 5.
She deserves to have the
spotlight. She won't kill it, but
it's really
she could out. She could do 2 wounds to it. She could leave it at death's door.
Yes, that's what I want.
So.
Oh, well then why don't... I can't attack from range anyway.
You couldn't attack. Yeah, you couldn't get into combat with it anyway, but... possible that it'll move, maybe move closer to you, so...
I want Gwen to have the big final blow.
2 attacks, I need 5s, and 5s to wound. Miss. Oh no, that's it.
Boo, Gwen.
Boo. Alright.
And now it's Kate.
Yeah.
What do you think? Actually, I think...
At least move in.
Yeah, much of either doesn't really matter, I guess.
Alright, you're the... Master now,
and it's gonna target me.
Okay, so does it turn?
We don't know what it does. Let's see what it does here.
Pick target.
Yeah, it's just
closest claw. Threat. And then claw attack.
So
two
yep.
attacks.
Yep.
And that needs a.
It needs a two.
Two hits, four and a six. On to Timothy.
Oh, do them one at a time.
Yep. I will spend survival to avoid one.
Okay.
Why don't you see where it hits first?
Oh no, yeah, I have to wait until...
Okay, potentially the best one.
Head.
For you I have no to dodge. Armor, so...
It would knock you down, so that's a good one to dodge.
Yeah. So I spent
okay,
that, so that.
Okay,
and
second.
Next one.
Body.
Yep. Okay. That's it.
That was body.
And then we shuffle these guys up again.
Pretty much you'll do that every time, I'm not sure. Oh. He's a very vocal cat.
So, now.
Nala is pretty vocal for a 2, only being a year and a half old.
Yuki's 11?
No, 12 now.
I know.
What up?
It's all hard done by.
Cats are sick.
But there's a lot to be said to me.
So, she could go around and get back attacks.
Yep.
He could come around and attack where she's attacking from and get attacks. Then he could go around and get back attacks. It's one possibility. But it means that if the cat leaps at all, it's bad. He could just back away. He could go around and she could go around and do back attacks.
Timothy doesn't have any... Sorry, not... Chris doesn't have any weapons?
He does. You just
remember, he can't grab now.
True. Okay. Mm. So then I suggest this. He moves.
Just attack right there, and then move.
Sure. Okay. Oh yeah. I can attack.
Oh yeah, because you can do it
either
way.
Yeah. All right. He needs 6. 2 hits. So he can't do grab. He'll still move though. But he can't move.
So it'll still be a collision.
Okay.
That's if you fail?
That's a reflex. He's doing that automatically. Okay. So I guess I'll do this one first. Yeah. Oh, yeah, this is the dong hit. Alright. I need. 6 to wound.
Oh, wow.
6 to wound. No wound. Second hit. 6 to wound. A critical.
Oh, missed that
I cancelled it. White Lion's tail is destroyed. We get one lion tail.
Sick. We're gonna cook the lion tail?
It's
solid meat.
Make it into a bow or something.
I guess it would be like a giant tendon or something.
I'm not sure what.
Soak it in water and make it.
I haven't seen the ingredient or what recipes we can make with the tail yet.
Lion Tail Stew.
So then he'll back up. It's surprisingly heavy.
I wouldn't be surprised at all.
Not brother?
I wouldn't be surprised at all. How would it say the weight is?
What does it say the weight is?
Sorry.
Oh, right.
Kangaroo tails are extremely heavy as well.
Yeah.
Just dense meat. Just muscle.
So it moves forward?
I canceled it with the crit.
Okay.
Yeah, what is the collision?
We just move forward and get knocked down.
Okay.
But here's the other thing. When a monster moved to impassable terrain, monster moves through impassable terrain, unimpeded.
Oh, it just pops out on the other side?
So it would have been there.
Yeah, but we were standing here, so what happens?
It can't attack.
But it can't sit on the train.
Yes.
Oh, it can't. Oh, okay.
That's a new thing.
Okay.
Hmm. Impassable terrain's only for us, not for monsters. Mm.
It's almost a hindrance.
So what?
Wait.
I guess it just means you can't. You can hide from it, so you're not a target. Yeah. If it sees you, though, it can attack you.
Seems kind of. Cool.
That's when it does something that moves through. Like,
yeah.
And it forces it to move there. Otherwise.
Sure. Yeah. Okay. That was Chris's attack.
Come on, make some damage. We need to knock this thing out.
Gwen still has survival, so if Timothy wants to run around behind it.
Yep. Which is also good because the monster will turn around to face me if I don't kill it.
If it attacks you.
It will.
Priority.
It always attacks you?
Because that... that crit I got.
But I mean,
it
has to actually attack you, though, in order for it to turn around. I mean, if the
I'm always the target now.
Yeah, but what I mean,
when a monster performs a pick a target action,
it has to do a pick a form. Like, if you attack it and just do wounds to it, it's not going to turn around.
No.
Yeah.
No, but I'm saying.
Until the next turn.
Yeah,
until the next turn, it becomes the target anyway. Yeah.
Two hits.
Good hit.
First one, 5 plus.
Whoa. The next one. I guess this doesn't matter. So it makes a basic attack on you? It does turn around.
Yeah.
Oh, this is all going to shuffle in. You can't use survival to dodge since you don't have it anyway.
For the basic attack.
Two's up.
Two plus.
So.
That was supposed to be him, wasn't it?
Who did you go to?
What? Priority target.
What?
Oh no, priority target. No, who has the monster card?
Oh, no.
You have the monster card now.
So, one hit. Location.
But it's kind of irrelevant at this point.
Body.
You knocked down. Who's got... Gwen can get you to stand up. Oh, it doesn't matter though.
I put two still.
Yeah.
I could do it.
This is... It doesn't really matter if you stand up. Because he's already done his attack. He doesn't lose actions because he's knocked down.
Alright.
Does the monster get bonuses to do something to you when you're knocked down? No.
Okay. Kate's turn?
Sure.
Let's move Kate up, I think, to attack, because from what you're saying, after we get rid of the last AI card, the monster isn't actually dead yet, is it?
No, he needs one more hit, yeah.
Well, let's use Kate to try and get him down to his last hit, and then Gwen can finish
him
off. Gwen can be the hero. Okay.
Go for it.
Okay. So, two dice.
Two dice, yeah.
One at a time, though? Is that what we...
No. Roll them both now. Ah.
One hit.
And so now...
Mutation?
Oh, here.
Beast's heal.
So nothing happens if you fail or... There's no reaction from the monster. So you just roll to wound it now. And you roll the dice, add your strength, which is 2, and you need to get an 8.
So I need...
Basically a 6 or 6. Oh, critical.
So I get no point. No. Nope.
It means that you ruin the monster's straining tendon. The white line is knocked down.
Sweet.
That's really good. Then nice. Gwen's going to have a good chance to hit it. You ruptured a tendon. Every time it moves, on a roll of a 1 on a d10, it's knocked down. And you do...
So do I get my... Oh.
That's the last one. So when Gwen goes now, this is the killing blow.
She's hitting on 3 pluses. 2 hits.
2 hits.
Good, Gwen. Blind, Tourette's yelling, crazy
so
woman.
So this is, we'll do this one first.
With an antelope mask.
Yeah.
Screaming antelope.
I need
just that guy there.
I need a 5.
So are these the only ones you've done?
Yeah. So I killed it.
Are there more?
Do I roll this one?
Yep. Yeah, you see the other guy there, that's a butcher. And then there's the Hand, Gold Smoke Knight, there's the Watcher, and then the Phoenix.
So that's it, he's dead.
Dead?
Yeah. So now we get 4 basic loot and 4 oh. lion loot.
Loot!
Yeah. And we actually have a viewer.
someone's watching us live.
You must have an entertaining day, eh?
What is the time?
Watcher.
Hello,
so
viewer.
Level 1. 4 basic resources.
Wine. It must be alcohol. We found alcohol.
Yeah, love juice. That's good. The love juice.
We didn't get the lion's claw out of this, so it's good that we found it in the. We also ripped one off, yeah.
Yeah, we got 2 of them, didn't we?
Yeah. A third one would have been great, though. We could make 4 of those things.
Jesus, we got some shit.
Yeah, we didn't get. A random survivor gains +1 insanity, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1. So, Chris. So, ugh. When we gain this, survivor of our choice gets +1 insanity. So, anybody particularly want 1 insanity?
We should give it to Chris.
He's got 3.
Yeah,
I've got 8.
Oh, you're just as insane as Gwen.
Tim has 6.
Okay, then Chris, look at it.
That's all of the... That's all of the... Those things.
Okay. Get rid of the battle board. More hit locations for the lion. Thank you.
Alright, so now we're back onto settlement. Oh, do you have that there?
How'd you have?
No. Settlement phase on the back of them. Alright. So remove all. No one took any crits, that's good. So we get to remove all
damage and stuff. Yep.
We also get something else.
We get one more hunt XP. Chris ages, so he gets to roll on that fighting art chart.
Is that what the
everyone gets
is that
one
heavy square is? No, wait, so we've all got the same marks on heavy.
So there was like a normal one there, then heavy.
Tim also ages. Everyone gets plus one weapon proficiency.
Where is that?
It's this one. We're gonna specialize soon.
And then we got the rewards.
Is that a streaming camera you got, Shane?
Yep.
How is it?
That's pretty good. It's doing 1080p.
Nice. Did you get one? How much was it?
That one was $100. Right, so that's all the stuff we get from that. So that's 7 days.
So yeah, now we're on this track here. And what this does is, so we set up some, and that means we put out all of our loot. Where's all the locations and innovations we have?
Yes, I'm
now. Yeah. Survivor's Return, which is what we just did basically.
There's a quick card for that. That kind of shows you what for.
This is the first place that we got, and then we made the Catarium, the Bonesmith, the Skinnery, and the Organ Grinder.
There's the ones that we have.
We have the Lantern Oven, we have Language, and we have Ammonia. Things we know how to do things with.
And now we picked up Intimacy.
We picked up Intimacy now, yeah.
Oh, so I got my Intimacy under.
One of us has to consume this thing.
Wait, was Intimacy an innovation, or was
It's Intimacy.
I need to go at 3, Shane.
Not a problem.
Perfect. Oh, look, archive this to look in the book, Intimacy. Okay. I don't know if we get it.
Oh.
No, there is no innovation Intimacy.
Yeah.
Oh.
So we got four endeavors.
Which is the settlement phase?
We're in the settlement phase now.
Whole thing? Okay, yeah, so I've been you can do this now.
Let's say when?
Wait, so wait, what?
In the settlement phase.
Aren't we in turn 2?
Sure, yeah, this one apparently can be done anywhere.
Oh.
So basically what we did is Survivor's Return, so you move all tokens, heal any existing light and heavy injuries.
Yep,
shoot down.
And then next one is gain endeavors. So there's our four endeavors.
Yeah, these are basically the man hours of work our characters can do. Is it for every survivor returning?
Yep. So each returning survivor generates one innovation. Abilities may modify the amount.
Yeah, okay. Only the people that went out on the hunt can do stuff back at home.
Then what is this? Let's do the
yeah.
This one.
Yeah.
Because then we have to draw the card to find out.
So I already got our. Where's the.
So basically, if you look on the card here, that little book, that means that's a story event. So then I flip through here. Intimacy. First time you settlement gives birth to a new survivor game, plus one populace from Intimacy.
Plus one population?
Mm-hmm. So nominate one consenting male, one consenting female. Remember, consent is important.
Sure, yeah. Fair enough.
So who are we going to do?
Kate, I think Kate should be voted.
Yeah.
Kate?
Sure. Okay. Kate and Tim.
Tim is the de facto leader.
The leader at the moment.
Sure. It should go to Tim. He should have all the spoils. All
right.
Kate was turned on by his braveness with the new weapons.
Good on you, right. Kate. Way to increase the population.
Roll a D10. Let's see. The first time your settlement gives birth to a new survivor, gains plus one.
Where's the settlement chart? Where's our settlement paper? Oh. Carry on.
So roll on the table.
Roll?
Yeah.
Two.
Oh. Not good. Oh. You had a bad feeling about Kate? Well, here it comes true. Kate dies during childbirth.
Oh. Okay.
Well, that's good. That's all right.
Casting gloom, male survivor mourns, gaining a Ren disorder and plus three insanity. Oh. All
right.
Timothy.
Did the baby survive?
Can we go the baby?
Perishes with her child.
Oh. Right. Nothing good comes from this.
So did the population went up?
Is now
because
down
of the
one.
Baby?
No, like it doesn't.
It said our population went up by one, right?
No.
No, it perishes with the child.
Okay.
So our population actually goes down.
Yeah.
One. And we Rafila's leader is not doing well.
Yeah.
He's struggling.
Gains a random disorder. And his random disorder is...
So
apathetic. Oh, you've given up. Nothing seems to matter. You have no concern of your own well-being.
You weren't born in this game. So you were extinguished on Yantern Year 3.
Oh.
Rest in peace, Kate.
Yeah.
That's fitting.
The disorder is very fitting. Apathetic.
Ah.
So you've given up. Nothing seems to matter. You have no concern for your own well-being.
That could be
good. You cannot use or gain survival. And you cannot gain courage.
Oh, Jesus.
Maybe that's not good, but maybe you're just...
Cure disorder if you have 8 plus understanding.
You see, Shane, sometimes...
bad thing happens to good people.
Yeah. That was really looking good, dude. Having a baby and everything's coming up really nice. Rest in peace. So I guess I can clean this up then, can't we?
We'll keep the information because an archive of all the people who died.
I think that's just gonna make morale low. It's best if we just forget. I think.
Yeah. Lost.
Deceased.
Yeah.
Lost. Wow.
That didn't go well. Kate, it did not go well. But you get to keep her items, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Alright.
Can we get two broken lanterns and one curious hand? Those were the things we had left.
Can you use survival to skip that?
No.
Survival can only be used
in battle.
Oh, no, it can just be recorded on there.
Sure.
It was what? Two broken lanterns, which are just scrap?
Yeah.
Two scrap and anything?
Two scrap and one curious hand, which we have right here. Okay. Death count, one.
Is that the first one to die?
Is that officially two death count, though?
No.
Okay. That was the first death, so we We go to first time death is updated, principal death.
Maybe she rises from the ashes. Jokes. I wasn't actually dead.
Get another innovation. Punked.
Principal death.
So it's going
to
be
okay, so the group must decide what to do with their first survivor corpse. Choose one. The first harvest, the first grave.
Was that the first harvest?
Yeah.
Grave, I think. I don't think harvest sounds like it's going
to... We have a lot of stuff here. We don't have to devolve our settlement into like something awful yet. So,
yeah,
grave.
I agree.
So,
grave.
2-1 for grave?
Yeah.
Alright. Settlement size is bailed. A small monument to mark their loss. Settlement gains death principles, graves.
So we're obviously not allowed to know the option, like what the result is?
No. Then we've still got a roll.
Where is
what?
This?
I don't think you listened to the question.
Of choosing graves, you mean?
Yeah,
we're gonna see in a moment.
Yeah, but could we have known first? Because
you get to choose.
Yeah, but he's saying what are the results of both of them?
Yeah,
like what do we get if we choose?
Are we allowed to know that information?
Yeah,
or
it's right there.
Yeah. Why don't we know? Why don't we hear?
Sure.
I prefer just with the game because you're still learning. Going to blind.
Just going to blind. Yeah.
Is it?
What are you looking for? Death principles?
Yeah. It says, yeah, settlement gains death principle graves, so or death principles cannibalize. But,
so me, I'm not sure what these.
Basic resources, disorders, fighting arts, innovations. Is that under innovations?
That's not. Lion tail.
There
I'll see you. We can totally make a bow. Catgut bow.
And then we can make another
clawhead arrow.
All survivors gain +1 understanding. That's cool. So
all new survivors.
All new survivors.
When a survivor. Sorry. I'm just seeing. Yeah, I was going to see if any of these cards have death principles on it.
When a survivor dies during the hunt or showdown phase, we gain +2. Oh, okay. So when we die, do we get that now? I guess not. Yeah, when a survivor dies during the settlement phase, game one.
Hmm.
Our characters become more industrious when we lose people.
Her legend will live on.
Yeah.
Gone, but never forgotten.
We'll have a holiday. It's a work holiday.
Yeah.
The cake day.
But who pays for it?
Who pays for the holiday?
Yeah.
Everyone else.
It's not really a holiday then, is it?
It's not like a holiday as in like it's a day off holiday. It's a holiday as in like an honorary.
Roll
a
d10.
Should be a day off.
Yeah.
Roll a d10.
Six.
Nominate a survivor. With tears in their eyes, the survivor takes a shard of rock from the grave and marks himself with it. They cherish this mark forever. The survivor gains +1 permanent luck.
Tim.
Yeah.
No, but if he's not motivated to do anything, what if that makes him sit out, then we won't actually get the benefit?
No, I don't know.
He doesn't sit out of the fights, right?
No.
Yeah, yeah.
How do you know?
Because we know.
It would have said game rule stuff.
Yeah, because there's an actual thing that it's like you can't fight in the next one. So, him having luck is great because the Katars are already lucky. Do they give you luck?
Gives you plus one luck.
Okay,
so with my other plus of you,
yeah,
plus
two luck. he's critting on eights now, which is like really good. No, because he gets to roll four dice when he attacks,
yes,
and crits on eights.
So,
or whoever has the Katars, which will likely be Tim.
Which is good, because, yeah, he'll be our DPS.
But now he's not motivated to do anything, man.
That means he doesn't gain courage?
Yeah, which is that.
So it's not
I can't cure it. If I get understanding up to eight,
yeah,
he cures that.
You're a long way off that, though.
He's the highest of us so far.
Yeah, I'm an understanding right now. Two.
Two. Yeah, that's the highest of us all. So.
All right, so let's go through age.
Yeah.
We had a few guys.
Yeah, age. Two true age.
Okay, let's find age. We'll get this all done before we draw the event.
Yeah.
Old.
What's the event?
We don't know yet. Just like what happens this year, basically.
Right.
But these two characters aged before that happens.
All right, so roll 2d10. Add them together.
Eight.
You have gained one random fighting part.
Nice.
Shuffle up and then for Timothy, 7.
Roll 2.
Got it. Okay. Got 5, 13. Same random art. Fighting art.
12.
7 to 15 is random fighting art.
13.
If I
Timeless Eye. That's the same one that went to.
Okay, give me the pile.
You attack roll is now on a 9 or a 10. Perfect hit on a 9 or a 10. What's a perfect hit? What's a perfect hit?
That's the 0. That's a crit.
That's for wounding.
Oh, perfect hit.
Yeah. 10 is a perfect hit. That does something, I think. I think we've been missing that. Because, yeah, when this perfect hits, it gains plus 4 strength. Maybe that's all it is. Maybe it's like it triggers abilities that have to work off of a perfect hit, but it doesn't do anything itself.
Okay, my fighting art is Last Man Standing.
Attack roll results in Lantern 10. This result always results in a hit. When there are multiple perfect hits in a single attack, trigger any rules applying to a perfect hit that many times. Oh, okay. So you just can't miss on a perfect hit. That's all. And it'll trigger perfect hit abilities.
So a 10 always hits.
Yeah. And for these characters, Chris and Gwen, if Gwen wasn't blind, they hit on 9. But we haven't seen anything that we need more than that yet.
So if Timothy is the last guy on the board, everyone else is down. He does no longer takes bleeding tokens and cannot be knocked down.
Beast mode, Timothy.
That's because he just doesn't care anymore.
Huh?
That's because he doesn't care anymore.
Yeah.
Screw you guys.
You took Kate away from me. Blood curdling scream.
Okay, so that.
Kate.
I've not seen the rules for that, but according to the upper right-hand corner, once per lifetime, reroll available.
So once, ever?
I'm going to look that up. If we actually get that.
Yeah, that would be a good time to reroll that.
Reroll what?
Reroll that botched pregnancy rule?
Yeah.
But surely you couldn't do it for events past.
It's not so far past that we can't fix it. If, like yeah, usually if things have, like, we haven't drawn the next.
But theoretically.
Oh, I guess we've chosen the grave.
You've chosen it with these are all results.
Yeah.
That's right. If we chose it, it didn't happen, then we wouldn't have got the.
Yeah.
Still want to find that.
Oh.
Well, everything. The only thing that wouldn't have happened so far is we wouldn't have gotten this. But we did choose that.
Yeah, but isn't that a direct result of how he.
No, the thing that he got was because he aged, which happened actually.
Could have happened earlier.
Yeah, it did happen earlier, yeah.
Gray area.
A little bit. This is like. For us.
I think we should leave it up to you, Shane. No decision to make.
I can't even find it. That's something I'll have to look in. Yeah. I don't remember seeing anything for that.
Yeah.
You're staying dead, Kate.
Unfortunately.
Yep.
Okay, so that was that. That was that. So we got. So everyone's story event that was on their card has been resolved.
Sorry?
Everyone's story events on their cards have been resolved.
Story events on their cards.
Yeah, like bold, like the.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Drawing the card.
Clinging mist. Symbol is hidden behind a thick green mist. Something about the way the lantern light passes through it seems to make it alive. Roll a d10.
Roll the red one.
Shane, roll.
I'm reading it. Someone else roll.
Oh, isn't that your thing?
No.
Oh, I don't like twos.
Yeah, it's exactly.
Where mist touches the skin, bright red boils bloom into existence. A painful boil leaves the survivors desperately scratching themselves.
Ugh.
Returning survivors suffer the worst. And must all skip the next hunt.
Oh, it's a newbie hunt.
That's not too bad.
At least it spreads the wealth.
Yeah.
Where is that?
Now you're back on. Now you're all on my page again. I've lost Kate. Now you guys have all kind of lost your guys.
You're gonna sit down around.
Where is that on here?
Twos are not good.
We're looking forward to where we can't go on the next hunt?
On the main card before everything gets transferred over to the permit card. Ah, there we go. Under impairments.
So, what was I about to ask? I forgot. What was it?
Okay, update the lantern year. Trigger any story events.
Story event.
What story event?
It's just story event. Like, it's just a card story event. So we just do, like, a regular story event, I guess, which is what you just did, right?
That was settlement event.
This is settlement event, right?
Nope. I'm just doing settlement event on here.
So I checked the third box, and there's just a card that says SE on it. I don't know if that's story event or settlement event.
Oh yeah, that'd be settlement event.
Yeah, we just did that, right? Yeah. So this is just a normal year.
Next year we have the Nemesis encounter.
Yeah, then.
So.
Well, that's good, because we'll send off the noobs, and they'll get to kill a lion, or an antelope.
Oh, no, it's... update timeline, that's when we would have done the story events. So like the age,
okay.
The death.
Okay. So the settlement event.
And then update death count, which we've done. Check milestones. We
would have had the first child born, but we don't. We would have had population reached 15, but we don't. And
thanks, Chris.
That's it. Yeah.
Oh yeah, so I was gonna ask. So is two always the worst?
Generally, one is like low is bad and high, high is good.
But yeah, it's actually generally. it's scaled so high is good, low is bad.
Usually, I guess.
Yeah.
That's
okay.
What I found.
Yeah.
So now we do development.
But it's obviously not scattered that you could draw a 9 and be like, yes, you're all dead.
Happened.
Unless all the other situations were
no.
significantly worse.
We haven't actually seen enough results on the charts to know that for sure. But I think that's right.
Yeah.
So
and then you would think they'd keep it linear with high numbers or being a relief.
Okay. What do we need for another innovation?
For another innovation, we need I don't think we can get it. We need bone, organ, and hide. And the way I figure it, there is the other Qatar.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Qatar was under what?
Qatarin. There is a cat gut bow.
That's also the same thing?
It's called a cat gut bow. There is a claw head arrow.
Just one arrow?
Yeah, although hang on. Instead of making the arrow, maybe we want to build the innovation.
We got cat gut bow.
The bone.
We're looking for the other guitar.
Hide and the organ. Let's use this organ. Monster organ. So yeah, that's our innovation right there. That leaves us with white fur, golden whiskers, and a strange hand, or curious hand left. Hide. We could make some armor, hide armor with that.
Ooh, we can actually have four guitars.
So what was that? It would be really annoying if they only gave you three of them. I think that's what we'll do. How good is the clawhead arrow? What does it do?
Clawhead arrow, slow ammo, bow, must have a bow in your gear grid to activate this. If you hit, monster gains minus one evasion token.
Minus
one per showdown. So it's a one-shot
arrow. One-shot arrow that gives it minus one evasion if...
It's one-shot if you hit.
Yeah.
Might be good if we're going against antelope, which that might have high.
Yeah, it's either that or we get an innovation.
I say we go for an innovation.
I say we go for innovation, yeah.
Chris, unfortunately your vote does not count.
What?
Because it's already two for the innovation.
I was three for the innovation.
Okay.
Judging on the last battle, it doesn't seem like we have any issue.
Okay, innovation so up there. What was it? Draw two, choose one?
Yeah. Bloodletting or a shrine. So we get breathing vein. Spend one resource and roll 1d10. Gain understanding. Lose all survival. You cannot gain survival until settlement phase for any reason. So plus 3 insanity. Cured. Gain plus 6 insanity. You may remove one of the following: warped pelvis, intestinal prolapse, or
that's getting close to that level where she eats fingers.
Oh, we need to make a shrine. Well, the shrine seems more immediately useful. We can send a guy, we can use endeavors, and you roll a d10. On a 4 or more, we all get plus 1 in every armor location.
Oh. Forever? Oh my.
For that journey.
Yeah, that'd be good for the
shrine.
Yeah, and that gives us faith, inner lantern consequences.
Uh, I don't see Shrine on here.
If we're here.
Yeah, no, I was wondering if it was another card.
Oh. But we get Faith and Inner Lantern with Consequences added to our draw deck.
But yeah, you can.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Is
it
V? Yeah.
Ooh. No pets.
Nope.
No pets. No sudden movements for any cat, Shane.
It's already in there.
I dodged it.
Oh, it's like it could be possibly in there. Let's see.
So, do we have? Are there any other? That we don't have a big event for this year.
That was it. The event was the acid rain.
The fog stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. Will this be a good part for me to leave?
We're almost to.
We're not done with what we need to do for our turn.
Maybe another five, ten minutes.
We spend these things and that's it.
Cool. Yeah. Which I lost.
So where's the card?
Oh yeah.
I sacrifice.
Yeah. That's right. We could use that.
We still use that before.
Yeah. We just get one for each. So
yeah.
Return.
Oh, yeah. Return. And yeah. She died afterwards.
Yeah. She died 9 months later. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. That's true. She did work before she died.
Yeah. Okay.
Very
fun. So it's not for nothing then.
Yeah.
Parked my truck in some, like over the street, behind their building. It's like no unauthorized parking will be towed. You wouldn't think they'd check on Sundays.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So what are all those? Is that a game as well, Shane? All those miniatures?
Yeah, Star Wars ones. Yeah.
Left is X-Wing. The right is Armada.
Good. So do they come painted then? Those ones?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. X-Wing is considerably easier than this. If you're interested in playing, yeah.
And then the models on the
bottom. Because those models, they're sticking by themselves.
Yeah. The ones on the bottom is the same game, but it's when you go up to what's called Epic.
Like a higher cap?
You've got big battleships on them.
Oh, so. Okay.
All of those things in that cabinet are for one game, and then the things in the other cabinet are for a different scale of fighting. Yeah.
So if you see the ship in the very back. The Raider, and then you take a look at Armada. It's the one second shelf on the left.
Same shit.
Yeah. What is that? I've never seen that one before.
They made it for that, the game company that makes those toys. They were licensed to make a new ship for Star Wars, and that's what they made.
That's pretty sick. So what is it like?
It's like you know the ship in Star Wars, the very first one, that one right there, the Corellian Corvette.
Yep.
That guy. It's sort of like an Imperial counterpart to it.
Is that the medical frigate one?
No, medical frigate one is the Nebulon B. It's in the top shelf there, and in the middle. It looks like an outboard motor.
Okay, so we got the shrine. Now we got to build stuff, and then I think that's it.
Well, then how is that scale wise? Then, what does that do? Because that looks.
So that one down there, the first ship you see.
It looks like a miniature.
It's
a miniature Death Star.
There.
Yeah, but the miniature the miniature Death Star looking one, this one, which is the one.
Yeah.
Yeah. What scale is that compared to that
same,
one?
Same. Same. These are all the same game. Right. These guys here. Yeah.
So that's basically the other team's equivalent.
Yeah, that's right.
Yes. Okay.
All right. So Timothy is updated. Kate, where is she?
Kate's dead.
Yep.
Katie's no longer.
But you can have your card.
Fill this out, you mean?
Yeah.
All right, so I don't think there's anything on here.
Only player to die, Chris.
Interesting. Green does not come off very easily.
Yeah. I had to rub it hard to get it off.
Oh, we lost the strategy ability.
It wasn't really that useful anyway, because it didn't affect the.
It in.
I guess it sort of directs
you.
You can hide from
the creatures. If they know you're there, they'll still attack you. But if they don't know you're there because you're hiding,
at least it'll allow us to know where the sort of half predict the next motions of the beast anyway.
And the other one here.
Yeah, once per lifetime.
The mask where you can put like the face down. You can jump up on top there and get like
range
accuracy bonuses. Yeah, that was quite cool.
Oh, well, then we kind of wasted building the... Well, not really.
The bow is still good.
It's always going to be handy to have.
The bow is still good, I think. I actually don't know.
So what else do we need to build? So this is used up?
That's used up. That's used up.
What about this?
Those are all used up. This is what we had left. That's used up.
The love juice. That ended up in death.
Misery.
So is
Gary.
Updated?
Gary was...
Gary stayed home.
But Gwen and Chris, where are they?
Gary!
So we did one innovation, what else did we...
Where's Gwen and Chris's car, paper? We haven't spent these yet. Oh,
we did one.
We spent one, yeah.
So we should have three?
Yeah, so I'd say we spend another one for the shrine to get that armor bonus.
Okay.
And
roll seven.
Yeah.
Yep.
And then...
So write that on the sheet. So make a note of that on the settlement sheet.
Is that called shrine?
Yep.
What's it, check gear or something? Last gear check.
Hmm? What, this?
Yeah.
Armor ritual.
Yeah, what the result we got was like final gear
final check. Adjustments.
Yeah. One thing that we could do, I think.
What do we have
for resources?
Yeah.
So we have two broken lanterns, which are scrap.
Yeah.
We have one curious hand, which is hide. We have one lion tail, which is hide. We have one whiskers, golden whiskers, which is organ. And we have one white fur, which is hide.
That doesn't allow us to do anything. No, these cards.
All the hides. Yeah, the hide. The we can make armor with the hide.
No, I'm just saying for the. Like trying to build anything, we don't have enough of anything.
We can't in the leather shop or whatever. Don't we? Can't we make?
We can make stuff. We can't build another.
Oh! I see what you're saying. Yeah. What should we make next? Weapon crafter, leather worker, or stone circle.
I don't know what else we can spend our endeavors on.
One of them had, there was something that we could, yeah, here, augury.
Oh, there we go. No, because we need an understanding of 3 or higher.
Okay. To get an advantage.
Oh, that's the... Oh, plus one the result if it's over.
And also shared experiences where characters can teach other characters. Which we should use this maybe to teach our new guys something.
Or we can also make stone noses, that's what it was.
Right, okay. We already have lots of those.
think Timothy's going to make a roll.
He's going to do that?
Yep. But he gains plus one on his saddle.
Yay! Oh, closer towards the eight that we want.
Yep.
What do we get when he gets to eight?
But he also gets insight.
He loses the apathy.
I don't want that. I want you to have that forever.
Alright, so story event, apathy. Sorry, story event understanding. Story event insight.
You leveled up on understanding?
Yep.
Ah, so any one of those big boxes can trigger a story event.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. You'll see like,
yeah, any
the
of
first
solids.
Big box is insight, the second big box is white secret.
Oh, I don't think you want that.
Insight. In the settlement phase. Easy town. Eight. Plus one permanence, accuracy.
Nice. Sweet. Uh-oh. Timothy's setting up to die here.
Yeah. All your eggs in one basket.
Yeah.
Plus, he's a tinker, so whenever he returns, we get plus one endeavor.
Sweet.
Please don't die, Timothy. See you soon. It'll be a sad day. But that will lead to potential rising of a new leader.
Mm-hmm.
It could be even better.
Mm-hmm. And sorry, it was plus one.
Or everyone could just die as a result. Be leaderless.
So nominate a survivor that has two or more hunt XP.
So because he doesn't care anymore, he's a super awesome fighter. Well,
that's what I was thought. Like, it's going to result in him doing amazing things.
We have one more endeavor.
We have one more endeavor.
Okay.
And we can basically get
teach.
Yeah, we can teach one of our noobs one hunt XP.
I think that's a nice way to go out of Kate's role.
We'll do that.
Okay.
In Kate's memory.
Yeah.
So make a note with the unnamed survivor plus one hunt XP. Has everyone updated?
Yes, Katie's still there.
Yeah. I know. I need those. I need their sheets. Are they here? No, these are all blank.
I have Timothy, Kate, and Gary over here. There should be somewhere over there.
Gwen and Chris. I don't know.
What are you looking for?
Oh,
yeah. So these are recorded. That's our gear.
So then you re-divvy that out.
Yep.
Yeah, wow, how long has that been? What time did we actually start?
12:30.
It's been like 2.5 hours for one turn.
Mm-hmm.
It's a
one adventure.
We're still learning more and more. Could look up a little bit.
But do you think the further we get, like the more turns we get in there, and the levels and everything are all bigger, and the items are going to get bigger as well.
Yeah,
sort of stays
more,
around here.
Yeah, yeah. Every time we meet, probably like the one monster fight.
Have you seen all like the item cards? Or you don't want to know?
Not until we unlock that area.
Yeah, we don't know.
Do we know though if we can get as high up as like of actual like proper like forged steel swords and stuff?
I think so.
Oh yeah. And then when you start getting to like the bigger monsters, you can get like white lion armor,
like,
you can get phoenix armor, you can get
screaming
antelope.
I don't
armor.
Know if it gets into metal, but it'll
nope.
be like it does get into metal because I
forge.
Say it'll true, yeah.
You say I'm like a forge.
It'll get
stuff.
Into
yeah.
good stuff.
Yeah.
Well, we got heat here.
Do we have heat? I don't know if we have heat yet.
Lantern armor gives us heat, so you can actually start. So that was that, and then the next one would be preparing for...
Gwen managed to stay just as insane. She, she did not
insane.
Progress yet.
Equally insane.
I would think the next one we should still continue hunting
lions.
White lion, just because our crew is a novice.
All new?
Yeah.
I almost think it doesn't matter. I don't think our new crew was going in to fight that lion was actually that much more prepared than previously. It was the gear that made us more prepared. And the new crew will have that gear too. Yeah. So I think we could send them after the antelope. Not all of them might come back, but we could do it. We don't have to.
So the other thing for anyone listening, and Chris, with the expansions that come out, that actually replaces other stuff in the box.
Oh yeah, it's like a new card pack, like with probably a different color or something.
I think you mean the monsters, right?
Yeah. So like one of them, there's a creature called the Gorn. So that would replace the white lion.
Yeah. Well, it doesn't replace it. It gives us
more options.
It replaces it.
Oh.
So you use either the white lion or the Gorn
forever in that world.
Yep.
That's weird.
And once you move on from white lions, that's all fewer.
Yeah.
Well,
the white lions don't exist in that world.
Yeah. Well, except for the very first one.
Why wouldn't it be optional?
Because that's the way that it sets up.
Yeah, but like, why doesn't it just add another creature to the world? Why does it take away one? That's just a weird. It's a weird choice, design choice to me that they would make that.
Don't question Shane. Shane knows.
Well, my friends have played this game a bunch.
For at least one day.
No.
Jazz.
Didn't it just come out?
No, this is the second printing, basically.
Alright, so that's the end of this. Hope if you're watching it, you had fun. Have a good one.